handling the play-by-play. We're at Chapman Field in Cumberland Valley High School at Mechanicsburg, or in Mechanicsburg, I should say, for the PIAA Class 2A State Championship. Southern Columbia Tigers, 12-3, looking for their record 13th state championship. Westinghouse looking for their first ever state championship as the Bulldogs come in undefeated, 14-0. Tigers 12-3 in their 21st appearance. And we were just talking about him. There's Gavin Garcia right there. Casey walking here. And at this time, we're going to take the opportunity to thank our sponsors for making this broadcast possible. Aaron State Route 901 in Cole Township, the Academy Sports Center in Mount Carmel, Ace of Games in Eliesburg, Bear Hollow Home Maintenance, Best Cleaners in Pax Sinus, Loom Heating LLC on Center Street in Tharptown, Breakthrough Sewer and Drain in Pax Sinus, Briskevich Dentistry in Pax Sinus, The Crossroads Group and founders Josh and Jeremy Hoagland, Deadeye's Deddy's Joke of the Week on Instagram, EW's Kelsey's Deli and Hoagies in Shamokin, EasternPAFootball.com, GDK Development of Shamokin, H&P Construction in Coltmont, Hirsch Family Dentistry, Mount Carmel, Irish Isles Provision Company, Colt Township, the Kaiser Brothers with locations in Danville and Muncie, Glasic & Associates, West Independent Street in Shamokin, the Clebon Insurance Group in Eliesburg, Lisa Lebo, licensed massage therapist, Little Village Primitives, located in Eliesburg, the Manny Chiropractic Clinic and Dr. Philip Manny, Miller Gas and Oil, Myers and Lynch, The News Item, your local hometown newspaper, PBS Beverage in Pax Sinus and owner Steve Tahansky, Penn's Tavern located in Fisher's Ferry just south of Sunbury, The Plumbing Outlet between Shamokin and Coltmont, Pretty Petals and Gifts by Susan in Pax Sinus, R&M Disposal in Mount Carmel, Rhode Armel Springer Tax and Financial Services in Eliesburg, Bernie Romanowski, Chapter of the PA Sports Hall of Fame, SCATigerFootball.com, Chicotano Ace Hardware in Mount Carmel, Shimox Furniture in Coltmont, State Farm Agent Darla Fozzi, Studio 207 on North Liberty Street in Shamokin, Sunbury Motors in the North 4th Street Auto Plaza in Sunbury and on the Golden Strip in Hummel's Wharf, Triple Play Custom Apparel in Danville and on Facebook, UNB Bank, and these additional sponsors for this state championship broadcast for the Tigers: Roaring Creek Machine Company, Squeeze In, Wytovich Wislosky Investments, Sheer Color Studio, Denny's Automotive LLC, Southern Columbia's Football Boosters, Baseball Boosters, Girls Basketball Boosters, Wrestling Boosters, Girls Soccer Boosters, Boys Basketball Boosters, and the Track and Field and Cross Country Boosters, the Wise Family, the Federoff Family, the Sailor Family, Merle Schaefer, and the SCA Athletic Hall of Fame. So we're going to take a two-minute break and come back with tonight's, or I should say this afternoon's, starting lineups. You're listening to Black Diamond Sports Network and Bill 95.3. We'll be back in 2 minutes.
The Academy Sports Center is a proud supporter of all area teams. The Academy Sports Center is your area headquarters for customized apparel for all team sports. They also feature a complete selection of t-shirts, sweats, hats, hoodies, and other school logo items. If you need trophies or plaques, they can make them on site to suit your needs. Stop in and see the friendly personal owners and staff at Academy Sports Center located at 18 South Oak Street, Mount Carmel, or give them a call at 570-339-3399. Do you suffer from neck, back, or shoulder pain? Do you experience pain, numbness, or tingling in your arms or legs? Is your lifestyle hampered by headaches? If so, you could be like tens of thousands of other people who have found relief from these and other ailments through chiropractic care. Give Dr. Philip Manny of the Manny Chiropractic Clinic, 44 North Market Street in Shamokin, a call at 570-644-2225 to schedule your appointment. Most insurance is accepted, including auto and workers' compensation. That phone number again is 570-644-BACK back. Irish Isle Provision Company, Inc., 911 West Arch Street, Cole Township, specializes in USDA Choice Prime cuts of beef chicken, pork, and veal. Imported deli meats and cheeses along with brand name cold cuts are also available. In addition, they offer a variety of seafood. Check out the family pack specials and save. Phone-in orders are accepted at 570-648-6893 with local delivery optional. Delivery to restaurants, dinners, diners, delis, hoagie shops, etc. can be arranged. Earl Sheriff, owner-operator. Dr. Michael Briskevich and his staff at Briskevich Family Dentistry are proud to support Southern Columbia football on the road to Cumberland Valley. Their office is located in Paxinus across from the Vibenic Crossroads Strip Mall near the intersection of Routes 487 and 61. They serve patients of all ages and provide services in all disciplines of dentistry, including orthodontics. Call Dr. Michael Briskevich of Briskevich Family Dentistry at 570-509-2703 to set up an appointment today.
Okay, and now we're going to bring you today's starting lineups. And these starting lineups are being brought to you by
DW's, Kelsey's Deli and Hoagies, 545 North 6th Street, Shamokin, where they put the deli in delicious.
We'll start with Westinghouse on offense because that's who we're going to see first. The Bulldogs quarterback is senior Keyshawn Morcillo, halfback senior Khalil Taylor, the fullback senior Sean Robinson, so a veteran backfield. Wide receivers are senior Sincere Smith, junior Tamir O'Neill, and senior Davin Jones. Offensive lineman, right tackle is junior Zachary Hines, right guard junior Mike Harvey, center is junior Raymond Poindexter, left guard senior James Williams, left tackle senior Terrell Searcy, and the kicker is junior Musa Bangura. Defensively for the Bulldogs, they will go with a 4-3 defense. Defensive ends are twins, both juniors obviously, Michael Robinson and Nix A. Robinson. The defensive tackles, junior Sincere Shannon and senior Dante Taylor. Linebackers, senior Troy Brown, junior Tyjon Abrams, and senior Roderick Jeter. The cornerbacks, senior Deshaun Blackwell and freshman Keyshawn Robinson. The free safety will be junior Tamir Neal. Strong safety, senior Khalil Taylor. The punter is junior Michael Robinson.
DW's, Kelsey's, Deli and Hoagies, 545 North 6th Street, Shamokin, open 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Saturday. Offer hot and cold hoagies, assorted deli meats and cheeses, deli salads, including macaroni and potato, homemade soups, rice pudding, chips, pretzels, and a variety of drinks. Party trays are also available. DW's, Kelsey's, Deli and Hoagies affords you the option to dine in, take out, or phone 570-648-3354 with your order for pickup or delivery. $10 minimum and $3.50 fee applied for delivery. DW's, Kelsey's, Deli and Hoagies across from Wise Markets in Shamokin, they put the deli in delicious.
Now for Southern Columbia, Tigers run that wing T offense that we talk about and is well known. The quarterback is junior Blake Wise, halfbacks senior Braden Wislowski, and a rotation at the other side between juniors Rod Murphy and Carter Madden, fullback senior Wes Barnes. Wide receivers for the Tigers, senior Jake Teselewski and juniors Kyle Christman and Jake Hoy. Tight end for the Tigers, Ryan Kerstetter, a senior, and junior Colton Bloom. Right tackle is senior Chris Treshock. The right guard, senior Brett Horton. The center is a rotation between senior Aiden Barkavich and junior Robert Long. Left guard, sophomore Jude Bremigen. Left tackle, senior Logan Shero. The kicker for the Tigers is junior Isaac Carter. Defensively, the defensive ends will be senior Tyler Arnold and junior Colton Blum. Defensive tackles will be junior Isaac Carter and senior Nevin Deal. Inside linebackers for Southern will be senior Wes Barnes and sophomore Dom Federoff. The outside linebackers, both juniors Gavin Krebs and Carter Madden. In the secondary, for the Tigers. Cornerbacks will be senior Braden Wislowski and junior Kyle Chrisman. Senior Jake Tezaleski and junior Jake Hoy will also rotate in. The safety is junior Loudon Murphy, and Isaac Carter, the junior, also handles punting duties for Southern Columbia. So today's starting lineup was brought to you by
DW's Kelsey's Deli and Hoagies, 545 North 6th Street, Shamokin, where they put the deli in delicious.
We're about 10 minutes from kickoff. We're going to do a 2-minute break. You're listening to Black Diamond Sports Network and Bill 95.3. We'll be back in 2 minutes. The SCA Athletic Hall of Fame would like to wish the Tigers the best of luck as they go for state championship number 13. Good luck, Tigers, and a special shout out to Dom from coming a long way since tearing an ACL, from Harvey, Michelle, and Kalen Fedoroff. The Wytovich-Wislowski Investment Group would like to wish all area teams success throughout the sports season. As the year goes on, you have to start worrying about things like retirement planning. You will never forget your memories playing high school sports, especially today, football. Best wishes on a successful state championship game, Tigers, from Wytovich-Wislowski Investment Group. SCA Tiger Football Booster Club hopes Southern Columbia wins a 6th straight 2A state championship. Sheer Color Studios, specializing in color and cut, provides clients with outstanding salon services with a relaxed atmosphere while performing our craft exceptionally well. Experience life with beautiful color. Sheer Color Studio, located at 244 North Market Street in Elysburg. You can give them a call at 570-209-9911. Sheer Color Studio, we've got the color for you. Tiger Baseball Booster Club sends out their best wishes to the Tigers. From Roaring Creek Machine Company in Catawissa, Go Tigers, owned and operated by proud SCA football state champs 2002, 2003, and 2004, Roaring Creek Machine provides world-class additive manufacturing, precision machining, welding, and custom automation solutions. Are long lead times or labor shortages affecting your business? Does your business need design manufacturing or automation? Roaring Creek Machine has you covered. The SCA Tigers Girls Basketball Booster Club would like to take this chance to send their best wishes to the Tigers. So we're back here live from Chapman Field in Cumberland Valley, and not too long, Casey, till we see how this game's going to pan out. Again, the Tigers have won the toss. They will defer. The Bulldogs will get the ball to start the first quarter. Obviously, Southern Columbia's coaching staff has been in this position more than anyone else. For Westinghouse making their first appearance, they've never been in a position like this, but this is a new stadium as well in Cumberland Valley that the Tigers coaching staff has never dealt with either. It's just, obviously, no matter how many times you play in a game like this, the nerves are going to be there for both sides.
They are, Dave, and boy, we're starting to get a big crowd filling in here, the Westinghouse crowd that we're looking out leading their sideline and chants, the Southern Columbia crowd filling in. Nerves, I'm sure, for both ends. A real clash of styles, clash of communities. Couldn't be two different opponents coming in here. Southern Columbia with all the experience in the world. Westinghouse making their first appearance here in the state title. Dave, we're in for a tremendous afternoon of championship football today.
And as far as traveling distance, the Tigers traveled about 2 hours compared to the four-hour trek that Westinghouse had to make from Pittsburgh. This is the third state championship that will be played here in Mechanicsburg this weekend. Yesterday in the Class 1A final, it was District 3 champion Steelton Highspire defeating District 7 champion Union 22-8. Congratulations to the Rollers on a state championship, their fourth overall. And winning their second state championship in program history was Bishop McDevitt in last night's 4A final. Bishop McDevitt out of District 3 surprised a lot of people by defeating District 7 champion Aliquippa 41-18. Obviously, District 4 to Southern Columbia versus District 8 Westinghouse is what we're bringing you. Then tonight, the 5A championship should be a good one as District 12 champ Imhotep Charter takes on District 7 champion Pine Richland, two teams that have won state titles in the past. Tomorrow's 1 o'clock kickoff will be between District 12 champ Newman Gretti and District 7 champion Bell Vernon. And the 6A final, the final game of the weekend, tomorrow evening, will be St. Joseph's Prep out of District 12. They'll be the heavy favorites against District 3's Harrisburg. So to get to this point, Casey, obviously, you have to be elite. And yesterday's games, we saw talent on both sides of the ball. But obviously today, we're going to see that as well. In a 2A game, teams aren't as big, but we know we have athletes on the field for both sides.
You're going to see speed all over the field today. Westinghouse will come in and spread the ball out and fly to the ball defensively. Southern Columbia going to go right at you, but both teams with tremendous team speed, certainly going to be a very important factor in today's game. Dave.
We're going to take another two-minute break. You're listening to the best of Cole Region High School Football on the Black Diamond Sports Network and Bill 95.3. Best of luck, number 10, Blake Wise, and the rest of the SCA Tigers. Let's make this a six-peat. Love the Wise family. Southern Columbia Wrestling Boosters wish the Tigers the best of luck as they go for gold. Denny's Automotive LLC, located at 1149 New Media Drive in New Media. Denny Tezaleski, owner, is a proud supporter of Tiger Athletics. Stop by your local hometown mechanic for all your automotive needs. It is honest and fair pricing with 40 years experience. From PA inspections to engine and transmission repair, Denny's Automotive can care for your car and keep your family safe on the road. Call Denny's Automotive LLC at 570-336-8666 to schedule an appointment. Denny's Automotive LLC, where service counts. The three-time defending state champion single-A Tigers girls soccer team wishes the football team the best of luck in this game. Drive slow down Market Street in Sunbury and keep your eyes peeled to find the small but mighty squeeze in, bringing you the best hot dogs you'll find in the Susquehanna Valley, with specialty options that will satisfy any eater like the Cubano, the Reuben, and the squeeze dog. The squeeze in, your main squeeze since 1945, located at 448 1 half Market Street in Sunbury. Let's go Tigers. SCA Boys Basketball Booster Club would like to wish the Tigers luck as they go for gold number 13. Go Tigers from the Saylor family. Ian, a 2004 graduate, Ashley, a 2000 graduate, and Tiffany, 1999 graduate, are all Tiger alums. Former assistant football coach Pete Saylor, thanks for tuning in each week to the Black Diamond Sports Network down in Texas. The SCA Tiger track and field and cross country boosters wishes Southern Columbia luck as they are hoping to finish off this season with another state championship. Merle Schaefer, author of Roaring Tigers, sends his best to Southern Columbia as they go for title number 13. Copies of the book are still available for purchase. Don't miss out on your piece of history of the Tigers football program. Once again, that's from Merle Schaefer, the author of Roaring Tigers. And the SCA Tiger Football Alumni Association congratulates this Southern team on reaching the 21st state championship game in program history. Former SoCo players are invited to join by emailing the alumni at scatigerfootball.com or finding our private group on Facebook. Or you can contact Secretary Judy Lynn Weaver. The SCA Tiger Football alumni are always Tiger proud. So we're back here, Casey, and Southern Columbia, we're on their sideline in the press box, and you hear the roars from the crowd as the Tigers are making their way out of the locker rooms and onto the field. It's hard to judge which side. I'd imagine Southern Columbia has more fans here, but it's about half the size of the bleachers as the home side.
It looks like a great crowd for both sides. I'm actually a bit surprised. Westinghouse really brought the city of Pittsburgh with them here today. Is they're ready to take the field as well, Dave. Southern Columbia fans on their feet. The electricity is off the charts. They were in for one heck of a day of football.
They know how to do this. They've been here so many times. And then Westinghouse, right? You know, wet behind the ears, basically built this program up for the last 4 years, and here they are today. So completely different from an emotional standpoint, a preparation standpoint. It's going to be quite a conflict.
Speaking of preparation, you're a defensive guy. Listen, everybody knows Southern Columbia, what they run. They run this wing T. How do you think Westinghouse, who is very athletic and has a lot of speed, can match up and slow down a very vaunted running game for the Tigers?
It's going to be a challenge. You know, you don't get to see it, and you definitely don't get to see it with the speed and efficiency that Southern Columbia runs it. So Westinghouse is going to have their hands full. It comes down to reading keys, it comes down to fitting gaps, and it comes down to tackling. Tackle, 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 tackle. That's what it's all about.
All right, let's take a look at those Southern Columbia Tigers again. Once again, the champs from District 4. There is Jim Roth, the legendary head coach, in his 39th season with 483 wins, which ranks him sixth all-time in the U.S. of A. They beat Trinity in the semifinal to reach their 21st state championship game and their eighth in a row. They're looking for their 13th overall title and sixth in a row. This is a team that plays physical defense and can run the football. A guy that will be a two-way player for them today will be number three in Wes Barnes.
Wes Barnes, he's a fullback, everybody. There's a fullback in this football game, which is awesome. The wing T uses him. They're going to try and attack this Westinghouse defense vertically, right up the middle, right in between the tackles. And Barnes is a guy that does that, rushed for 255 yards last week. So he can do it, right? You look at all the other guys, all the motions and those types of things. The guy coming right at you is Barnes.
Meanwhile, this Bulldogs team is 14-0. They faced very little adversity on the field this season. There is Dante Green, their head coach, in his fourth season, 39-6. He's a 2005 graduate of Westinghouse, reaching the state championship game by beating Steel Valley. They had not won a PIAA game before this season. The school's been around 105 years. This is the first state championship appearance for them, and the first time in 25 years a City League team has made it into the PIAA final. Again, an athletic team that can score a lot of points. I got to keep an eye on is their senior halfback, Khalil Taylor.
Yeah, looking at Taylor out on the field during warmups, I mean, this guy looks the part. He looks like a guy that if you're playing defense, you got to know where he is all the time. They're going to hand him the football, 19 carries for over 150 yards last week and a touchdown in their win. He's a guy that Southern Columbia is going to have to track all day long and be aware of where he is.
So one of the things Jim Roth was telling me earlier this week, and also this week, was about what they want to do defensively. Before we talk about that, this is where these two teams are located. And you can see Westinghouse out of District 8, which is located in the very heart of the city of Pittsburgh. A long trip for these guys to make it here to Cumberland Valley High School. Meanwhile, Southern Columbia and Catawissa out of District 4, very much near Bloomsburg. We joke with Jim Roth that he had to put a new GPS because it's a brand new place to come from where he was normally driving to Hershey.
Yep, he figured it out. He's done this before.
All right, let's take a look at how these teams got here. We'll take a look first at Southern Columbia. They beat Trinity, Mercy Rule game last week, 42-7. Bishop Guilfoyle, 42-14. They avenged an earlier season loss to Mount Carmel when they lost to those guys 35-21. They beat them 48-18 in the District 4 final. They then beat Troy and Line Mountain to get to that point, easily winning. As you can see, they've scored over 40 points in five consecutive games. Meanwhile, Westinghouse also has faced little adversity. They beat Steel Valley 26-7 last week in a tremendous effort. They beat Farrell 34-6 and Central Clarion. The first three wins for them ever in the state tournament. Berlin was a District 5/8 sub-regional. They mercy ruled them 59-7. That was a wing T team in Chestnut Ridge. Out of District 5, they beat 48-15. So Jim Roth said this earlier this week that, listen, if we win the toss in big games, we like to defer. How important would the team like Westinghouse, where they haven't been in this atmosphere before. How important will it be for them to get off to a quick start?
It's going to be important. You know, when your offense is out there on the field, you want to get those points right away. You want to get a little momentum. You want to calm down. Again, this is the first time they've been in a game like this. Mm-hmm. So that's going to be – there's going to be a lot of nerves going out on that field during that first drive.
One of the things Dante Green told us, too, is, listen, we're trying to treat this like it's any other game. You guys were having at it. It's a 100-yard field no matter where you're playing, right? Just embrace the moment. And that's what I think he's going to try to do with his squad.
Yeah, that's easier said than done when you're dealing with 16 and 17-year-old kids.
That is very true. All right, well, we got a great matchup coming up between Southern Columbia and Westinghouse. Let's send it down to the field for the coin toss.
The field judge, Daniel Lennon. The side judge, Anthony Pochiccio. The back judge, Matthew Stahl. Your chain crew, Alan Brown, Damon Carter-Mann, and Sonia Esses.
Southern has won the toss, and they will defer. All right. Westinghouse will receive.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please rise for the presentation of our country's colors. The colors are being presented this afternoon by the Ligonier Valley High School Air Force Junior ROTC. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for a presentation of the Star Spangled Banner. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dover Senior, Kylie Snellbaker.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare.
A great rendition of the national anthem. And I tell you what, Brandon, great crowd on hand for this Friday afternoon game. You knew Southern Columbia, who, by the way, was out tailgating about quarter to 11 this morning. But Westinghouse, I mean, that's a haul coming from Pittsburgh. They have got a very boisterous and loud crowd. I don't think anybody on this Westinghouse side, which is our home side, is going to be sitting down today.
Yeah, no, this is exciting. This is a huge deal for the community, for the high school, for the program. You're talking to Coach Green before the game, and right, like this group of seniors, he was there, he was hired 4 years ago, mm-hmm. right? And this is the payoff, right? This is the payoff of all the growing pains, right? And the lessons learned to get here with this group of kids that were freshmen when you came in as a head coach. It's fulfilling, but you want to finish it, right? You want to finish it today.
Well, a couple of the things that he's talked about this week is that he learned a lot of the lessons as a player, again, at Westinghouse to carry that over. Now, so again, as we heard, Southern Columbia decided to defer, so this will be a Westinghouse kick that they'll take a knee. It'll be a touchback, so they'll start first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Take a look at the starting lineup defensively. Arnold, Deal, Carter, and Bloom, your front four for this Southern Columbia defense. Keep an eye on Dominic Fedoroff as well. He's awfully tough from the inside. Offensive line, Hines, Harvey, Poindexter, Williams, and Searcy, averaging well over 300 pounds. And keep an eye on Sincere Smith, number 8, the wide receiver. He's awfully dangerous on the perimeter. Penn State Health Sports Medicine is proud to support PCN's live coverage of the PIAA Football Championships as this year's starting lineup sponsor. Don't get sidelined with injuries. The experts at Penn State Health Sports Medicine help athletes of every level. First and 10, this is Kashawn Morcillo, the quarterback, empty. He'll throw, looking to his left, flushed out of the pocket. And they do a nice job of containing him, does Southern Columbia, a gain of close to 1. It'll bring up a second down and 9.
Good job. Great job on the back end by Southern Columbia, not giving Marcella any place to throw the football, and then a really nice job kind of rallying to the scramble.
Second down and 9, 4 receivers. Again, this is a spread offense. They'll run, Marcel to throw again. Whistles will stop the action. As immediate pressure from Gavin Krebs comes from the backside of the play.
False start. Offense, number 1. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Second down to 14 now for this Westinghouse Bulldogs team. Taylor, the lone back in the backfield with Marcel. He goes in motion. Little screen coming near side. It'll be complete, but they'll lose a yard back to the 15-yard line. So it'll bring up a third down and about 15.
I like the call there, a little rocket, little tunnel screen, right, trying to bring that number 1 receiver underneath. The offensive tackle just couldn't get out there quite fast enough. Great job by the DB playing zero coverage right there. Southern Columbia brought the house. Again, great call if they connect on that thing.
Third down at 15, Marcel rolling to his right, looking downfield deep. Receiver is there, nearly intercepted. Jake Tuzelewski is on the coverage for Southern Columbia, and this falls incomplete.
Trying to get that to Jones right there. And look, the sun's in his eyes. The sun is to the back of Westinghouse's offense right there. That ball was a moon ball way up in the air. Lost it. You see right there at the end, right? He's doing the old palms up like I can't see the football kind of deal.
Now, this was an area that Jim Roth thought they might be able to take advantage of, and that's the punting game. This is a Bulldogs team that hasn't punted a lot this year. So quickly, defense on the field as they let this one bounce for Southern Columbia, and they get great field position on the plus side of the 50-yard line as Barnes lets it bounce. Here's a look at the offense for this Southern Columbia team. Barnes at fullback. Again, keep an eye on a couple of guys. Brett Horton, 72, the right guard, and Jude Bremingen, the other guard, the left side. Those guys will be very active at pulling today. Richardson, Shannon, Taylor, and Robinson up front. Big defensive line, but defensively, Ty Abrams, the middle linebacker, flows all over the place, and Taylor, we talked about him, very effective from the secondary, along with Deshaun Blackwell, the one corner, number 1. Here's Barnes, going to bounce it outside. He's got a lot of room down the far sideline. He'll take over the speed. He'll get inside the 25, down to about the 22-yard line for a first down. And immediately bouncing that run outside.
Yep, it's just a little down play right there. They're working to get off tackle, and Barnes does a great job getting around the edge. Great blocking.
First and
10, 7 o'clock on the 22. And you just, you know, if you're Westinghouse, if you're the Bulldog defense right now, it's hey, don't panic, don't freak out, right? Get used to the way they run this thing. Try and get a stop here.
They go to a pro set this time, a gain or a loss of one.
And one of the things really important defensively against the wing tee, especially a team that hasn't had a ton of success throwing the football this year, like Southern Columbia, is get them, you know, negative plays early, right? If you can get them behind the sticks, off schedule, whatever those little football cliches are, get them into third and long situations, you're in a good spot.
That was Loudon Murphy for a loss of 2, second down and 12. And a false start on the right side of the offensive line, or left side of the offensive line for Southern Columbia.
False start, offense, number 30. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
And this is a team that does not like to throw the football. Blake Wise, who will start the game, has only attempted 96 passes this year. Now, they'll bring in Tyler Arnold, the defensive end quarterback, number 14, but he's only thrown one pass so far this year. So, again, they go to that pro set with Murphy and Barnes. Here's a toss to Wisolowski. Nowhere to go. There's that aggressive defense coming up for a gain of 1 down to the 28.
Man, he got stuck right there. A little toss sweep. Wisolowski, woo! Man, number 7 came up with a, that's O'Neal right there, came up with an absolute stick.
So 3rd and 17.
That's been, yeah. Wisolowski's kind of, he's dinged right
he's
there.
Feeling it.
That's a huge thing to keep an eye on right there. He's a monster.
3rd down, 16. Single setback is Barnes. Carter Madden in motion. They look over the middle. This will fall incomplete. Pressure's there. The coverage was there as well. They had both receivers in the pattern double cover.
Yep.
Well done.
Really nice defense right there. You know, Coach Green talked about, you know, they've seen this before. They've seen this. Oh, that's a nice. Oh, look at that. That's textbook right there coming around the backside. Troy Brown, outside linebacker, number 10. Good job, good pressure, good speed. Way to attack the throwing arm. I really like that. That's some stuff you see on Saturdays and Sundays.
So 4-down territory for this Southern Columbia offense. As we're just underway, the Tigers got to stop as necessary. They'll go 4th down and 16 from the 28-yard line. Back to passes Wise again, looking over the middle. And this will be knocked away at the last second, so it'll fall incomplete. He was looking for Carter Madden.
And not the strength of this Southern Columbia team when he's throwing the football. He had him, right? He had Madden running down the pipe, just overthrew it a little bit. Madden kind of turned around too soon to get that ball. Sometimes if you keep running there and try and catch it kind of over your shoulder. But a great stop by the Westinghouse defense right there. That's a way to get after it after a big run by Barnes to open it up.
First and 10, Marcillo keeps it himself. Up over the 30 to the 33, almost the 34-yard line. Gave him about 5.
Little designed QB run, and this, we were talking to Coach Roth about this before the game, and he said this was one of those things he was concerned about. When you run the quarterback, there's an extra blocker. There's an extra gap that you have to handle now. So from a run fit perspective, you know, defensively, you've got to understand that, and it changes things.
Inside handoff, Taylor with it. Gain of a couple up to the 35.
Tough run right there. That's what they need.
The ruling on the field is the runner was down. Third down.
As the ball came out down there on the far side. Couldn't see it from here.
Third down and 2. Both defenses winning the battle so far. Marcillo will straight keep left side. He'll have the first down and more. Lowers his head, and here he goes. He's inside the 40, the 30-yard line, and is taken down inside the 25, down to about the 21. That's the dangerous weapon that this quarterback is.
QB run. Again, there's an extra gap in there. You're one man short now, usually. What it means is you don't have a free hitter. Right, when you don't have a free hitter, defensively, you always want to try and have a free hitter in the run front, whether it's a safety or a linebacker. But when you add the extra blocker because of the quarterback run, it eliminates that guy. So you've got to be really gap sound. Really nice run right there. Marcillo did a great job.
Marcillo's run was for 42 yards. First and 10 inside the 25. Marcillo to throw. This one nearly intercepted. Tuzelowski had it. It'll fall incomplete.
Nice break on the ball there. A little play, a little pressure on Marcillo. Nice break on the ball right there. Number six, Jake Hoy. They're like cookie cutters out there. Like they're all tall and long. Like all their defensive backs and split ends for Southern Columbia. They all kind of look exactly the same. Tall, long kids.
Hoy's got about three interceptions this season. Big defensive play, second down and 10. Handoff inside to Taylor, and he's got room and he'll score.
Just a quick trap inside. Just a fast hitting play. Was through the front seven before you knew it. You're gonna see the left guard pulls, does a nice kick out block right there. And he just creases him. Taylor, touchdown.
Impressive second possession for Westinghouse. Now they'll come in for the PAT. This one's no good, wide left. All right, we'll step aside. 6:37 to go, first quarter, 6-0. Bulldogs from Westinghouse.
A huge party is coming, and you're invited. In 2026, America will celebrate 250 years as a nation. Now through 2026, watch PCN for special programming. Join us as we highlight Pennsylvania's contributions to the founding of our nation with Celebrating America's 250th in Pennsylvania. For more information, go to PCNTV.com. PCN is everything Pennsylvania.
All right, now listen up. You've got a job to do at the Farm Show. You've got to represent PCN. You have what you need. The PCN logo on your back, and you're squishy. So when a visitor comes to the PCN booth, you jump into their hand. Who's with me? That's right. Conserve your energy. Go get them.
The Pennsylvania Farm Show, starting January 7th.
Welcome back to Cumberland Valley High School. Big drive, second drive of the game for the Bulldogs of Westinghouse. Scoring at 6:37 to go, a 6-0 lead. Taylor with a touchdown. He had a big game last week as well, did Khalil Taylor. And, well, we got an example of what this offense can do, what they can provide.
Speed, it's speed, man. They absolutely got after right there. You see the weapons. They run hard. They run behind their shoulder pads. The O-line's doing a real nice job in the run game, too.
So Southern Columbia will start with pretty solid field position as they were stopped on four downs in their first possession. They'll start with at their own 34-yard line. Team that had to throw the ball twice. We said, kind of joked around, we might see eight passes today. We've seen two already.
Yep.
You're right that you want to put this team behind the chains, and that's what this Bulldogs defense did. Yep.
First and second down, you want to get them in negative sticks here.
UPMC is proud to support PCN's live coverage of the PIAA Football Championship as this year's Score Bar sponsor. UPMC is committed to treating and preventing sports injuries in student athletes. UPMC, life-changing medicine. Big run for Southern Columbia. First down run.
Wislowski, he's back in the game, which is good to see. He took a good shot in that last drive. And it's a good, powerful run, right? The O-line's coming in and pushing from behind. you know, Southern Columbia, they're not going to panic, right? They're going to keep doing what they do. They believe in this run game. Again, they know they can't get negative yardage on first and second down.
Madden, the motion back. Look, that quick hitter to Barnes. Now, again, this is what Jim Ross said. He wants to try to attack between the tackles, yep. whether they run their counter or their trap plays between the tackles, or they run the dive plays. That's what they want to establish, because they want to come right at this Bulldog defense.
Yes, they do, and that's what they're trying to establish. Right, you saw it on the first play with Wislowski, and you get Barnes right there. They're just going to keep kind of probing. What the Wing T does, they just keep probing, and they kind of figure out what you're doing, and then they have a play for it.
Second down and 10, no gain on that first down run play. Toss sweep near side, this time it's Barnes. He'll bounce it outside and taken down in the open field. A nice open field tackle made by Westinghouse.
I think that was Taylor right there. Making the play. Outside line, you see him right there, shot the block, number 9, boom. That's a nice tackle right there.
That's something that they knew was going to be a problem, Southern Columbia.
Yeah.
They wanted to block. They got to block second-level guys. So a big challenge for the wide receivers for Southern Columbia to block these talented defensive backs and linebackers for this Bulldog defense. Third down and 10. And Carter Madden motion back. He'll get it. This is a little counter. Now back the other way. Wislowski with it. Mm. And he'll get the necessary yards to move the chains down to the 41. Inside Bulldog territory.
That's a Wing T staple right there, that little counter back underneath. That's a third and long play. Anytime you get a Wing T team in third and long, that's one they like to run. Get you kind of, everybody's running one way, and you're reading your keys and doing everything right, and next thing you know, the other wing back is coming back across the formation with the ball in his hand.
First and 10 from the 42. 6-0 lead for the Bulldogs. Barnes, straight up the middle. Gain of a couple, down to the 38-yard line.
And out to number 3, Wes Barnes. He stopped at number 24, Ty Abrams. Second down.
Second down and 6 from the 38. Wislowski again. He'll test that right side. Still going. The entire defense for the Bulldogs gathered in, and he'll get inside the 31 down to the 30-yard line for another Southern Columbia first down.
Wislowski runs hard. I mean, just hard. Watches right up inside. Great lead blocks in there by everybody. But look at him. He runs through 2, 3, 4. He's still driving. Here comes the O-line pushing. Powerful. 5'11", 185-pound senior. Guy absolutely gets after. He's fun to watch carry the football.
And right side, Horton, Treshock. Treshock is a two-way player. The tackle, 74. They move the pile. First and 10 from the 30. Here comes Wislowski again. Looks like the same play off tackle. They'll run him out of bounds for close to no gain. Good swarming defense for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, that one hit a little bit further outside. They've had success, like Coach Ross said. They want to run between the tackles. And you've got to do both, right? Just because... You know, you've got to keep the defense honest. Run outside, run inside, throw. They're not going to throw the ball very much, but unless they have to. But you've got to kind of probe around the defense. But right now, they're definitely having more success running right at them than they are trying to run around them.
They're going to give him a loss of one back to the 31-yard line. So second down and 11. Clock's under 3 minutes as it stops at 2:58 as they went out of bounds. Barnes again. He'll bounce it to the right. Gain of a couple down inside the 30-yard line to about the 26.5. Let's make it to 27.
Yeah, and this is, you know, look, they went for it on fourth and long last time. They're going to go for it. They got four downs here. Nice run again in between the tackles, straight vertical. Like, there's not a lot of outside running there. The shoulders are square to the line of scrimmage after Barnes gets the ball.
Well, Madden's lined up as the H-back to the right, Wislowski to the left, and Barnes is the single back behind Blake Wise, the quarterback. That's Carter Madden in motion. He'll get it. Here comes that counterplay. Wislowski bounced outside and strung out nicely. What a great job by the Bulldogs defense to string that out for another loss, bring up a fourth and long.
Great job out there on the edge. I think that was Ty Abrams, maybe number 24 out there.
Yep.
Yep, right there, and some number 10 out on the edge. Troy Brown again showing up. You see the frustration right there, the body language. Wozlowski, not used to getting held up like that.
Now, and Sincere Shannon, 55, was out there. Here's 4th and 9. Do they put it up? Barnes is the only back in the backfield. There's Wise to throw, looking left, guns it out that way, and what a nice catch at the 20-yard line.
Wow.
That's Kyle Chrisman, I believe, that made the snare. It was Chrisman's 8th reception of the season.
Nice pass. That's a hard throw right there from the far hash out to the outside, the numbers. And Chrisman looks like he gets that thing. Tuck it in underneath. Oh, that looks clean to me.
Yep.
But the definition of a catch has changed so much over the last 15 years, I don't even try and guess anymore. But in high school, that's a catch right now.
Yeah, what a big conversion on 4th and 9 and a pass. We go back and the whistles will stop this play. This will be a false start on Southern Columbia.
False start. Offense, number 54. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Not what the Tigers, this is not what they need to do offensively. Now, again, they're in 4 downs. I think they cross midfield during 4 downs.
Oh, yeah, 100%. 100%. And that's what, they believe that they can get 5-6 yards of carry, right? So you've got time.
Here's Wozlowski again. Continues to keep those legs moving. What a great run inside the 20 down to the 17-yard line. Looked like he was up behind the left guard and Jude Bremingen that time on that trap play.
Yep, you see Bremingen coming around there. Misses the backer. That is a hard run right there by Wozlowski.
Wozlowski over 1,800 yards coming into this game, averaging 12.4 yards per carry. Here's 2nd down and 7. Barnes, wait a minute, whistles. Stop that before it could start.
Snap infraction. Offense, number 52. 5-yard penalty, still 2nd down.
Yeah, this is something right here that's going to drive Coach Roth crazy. I mean, it drives every coach crazy, but when you're on a roll and you're moving the ball, in the state title game against an offense like the Bulldogs offense, you can't miss an opportunity to score once you get down and you're close to the red zone. Shooting themselves in the foot now a couple times once they cross the 50.
Well, 2nd down and 12. Let's see if they get this off. They do. Barnes left side met immediately with nowhere to go. He maybe, and he does, get back to the line of scrimmage at the 22-yard line. So we're through one quarter of play from Chapman Field, and the Bulldogs looking to keep their undefeated season going and win a state championship. They have a 6-0 lead.
You can watch all of your favorite PCN originals and more at home or on the go. Download the PCN app on your favorite device and tune in to see what makes Pennsylvania's heart beat. Watch videos on demand, see multiple live streams, and check out the free selected programs and events. PCN, Pennsylvania politics and policy, history and culture, sports and more.
Here's the Tigers last year, a convincing win in the 2A championship, beating Sarah Catholic 62-25. A lot of familiar numbers and faces there playing for this Southern Columbia team, yes.
Yeah, look at that. just a machine, an absolute machine. They're fun. They're fun to watch. And Coach Ross done obviously done an amazing job there with that program. They just keep going. They do things the right way. It's kind of cookie cutters.
Well, he's got a big challenge here on third down and long. Wislowski again, who we saw in those highlights from last year, wants to keep it going. And he'll move this pile inside the 20-yard line down to the 19, just inside the 19, but again brings up a fourth down and long. This has been a similar, a very familiar down and distance for this Tigers offense so far today.
Yeah, which is not good. Not what you want. You know, fourth and long, and you, when you run the football is a challenge. They did convert on the on a third and long a minute ago, a really nice throw and catch, but not where they want to be, but they understand the importance of this drive and getting the first down and getting some points.
Fourth and nine. Wislowski in motion. Here's Wise to throw. Pressure right in his face, and he'll just throw this one incomplete. That front four has been tough to block on passing downs, and especially the predictable passing downs, because they can bring pressure yep. with an extra body if necessary.
Yeah, yeah. It's one thing when, you're a wing tee team and you throw the ball on first down, it's one thing, but fourth and long, not where you want to be, and he's got bodies in his face. He's having to move through the pocket. You know, Wise is not comfortable back there. Coach Green doing a great job. That defensive staff has put together a nice game plan, and his Bulldog defense is playing hard right now.
Well, Khalil Taylor's got the only touchdown so far today. That big run of 22 yards. First and 10 from the 19. Marcillo to throw, looking deep over the middle, just missed his target. It'll go incomplete.
That was Deshaun Blackwell running down the seam naked. You see him right up the hash here. Woo, there he goes. And just a touch off. Marcillo would love to have that one back. That's a touchdown if he connects right there. And he was just off. You'd rather overthrow that one than underthrow it, but he had Blackwell just screaming down the hash.
Just changing out the football, so they'll bring up a second down and 10 after the incompletion.
Please reset the play clock to 25 seconds.
Set to go, second down and 10. Marcillo keeps it himself. He'll bounce it out to the left side. Ball comes out, but after the play was whistled dead.
He's right down by number 26.
Marcillo's, he's hurt him a couple times. There's a little QB counter where you see two offensive linemen, the guard and the tackle pull. He fakes the handoff inside, and he's got a couple lead blockers. Gets around again. There's that extra gap, right? That run fit. Mm-hmm. You know, Coach Ross said, you know, George Curry said, if you got a running quarterback, it's like playing with 12 guys on offense. Nice play right there by the Southern Columbia D-line. Job knocking people backwards.
They lost a yard or two, back to the 26.
No place for Sean Robinson to go right there. Trying to that little quick hitter, that little trap that they scored on right there. Great job by the D-tackle. Getting that trap read and squeezing it down, not allowing the crease to happen in the A gap.
So fourth down and short, and the offense stays on the field.
Ooh.
Marcillo, plenty of time. Intercepted. No, dropped.
Oh my. Well, they get the ball there either
Doesn't
way.
Doesn't matter. That's right.
But still, that was
Fedorov.
Great job sitting low in the hole. You see Fedorov just mirroring the eyes of the quarterback, a little crossing route. They were running mesh right there. So you had two receivers running across the field, and Fedorov just sitting there at his middle linebacker spot. Had one go through his hands, but, I mean, that's a bold call right there by
yes,
Coach
it is.
Green. I know they haven't punted a lot this year, but you've now given, you know, the Tigers offense the ball really close to the goal line.
Well, just outside the 25, there's Barnes inside, down to the 21-yard line, taken down by Abrams there, number 24.
He's marked down by 24, Connor Abrams.
Getting straight ahead. Right. Southern Columbia has had success when they're hitting the hole with their shoulders square to the line of scrimmage. Not trying to run outside and off tackle where that speed, that Bulldogs defense that runs so well.
Gain of 5, second down and 5. There's Loudon Murphy inside the 20. That pile continues to move. They'll get it inside the 20, down to the 15. They'll move the chains once again. And new life and new energy for this Tigers offense after that fourth down stop.
Yeah, give a little Loudon Murphy, a little change up. You know, Barnes with a nice lead block right there. A little rugby scrum at the end. Everybody pushing everybody else. Moves the chains.
Murphy coming in, averaging 8.3 yards per carry, 439 yards. Nice little change of pace. They go offset or pro set once again. There's Wozlowski. And this is Barnes met, but he'll spin off one tackler, gain a couple, down to the 13-yard line. Give him a gain of 2, second down and 8.
There are some absolute collisions happening out there right now. Man, you see Barnes here, get that little handoff, whack, right there. Couldn't tell who that was. It looked like it was O'Neal again, number 7.
Yeah, Tamir O'Neal, yeah. Hit. All right, second down and 8. Ball to 13. Loud Murphy in motion. And they'll stop this one. The umpire with the flag. That could be another infraction on the center.
False start. Offense, number 54.
Huh. Nope.
5-yard penalty.
You wonder, Brandon, how much of this has to do with the concern of who I got to block.
Yeah, right? No doubt about it. And it's very uncharacteristic of kind of a Jim Roth offense, right? They're usually it's a very clean game that they play most of the time. And, it's the second quarter of a state final game. It's a big deal. So you get a little jittery. And one thing that the Bulldogs are doing is they are stemming. They are moving their front a little bit. So it does create some issues.
Toss to Wozlowski. He'll bounce it to the left. Got a block by Chrisman and dives forward inside the 5. This will be close to another first down. Looks like he's got enough to move the chains, and he will. This could be a first and goal.
Nice job out there on the edge. And the Bulldogs faithful here in front of us were looking for a holding call out there on the guys blocking for Wozlowski, but didn't look too bad. Nice run, 14 yards. They're going to try, obviously, you get the ball handed to you on the 26. You want to punch this thing in.
They'll go T formation now. First and goal from the 4. Here's Murphy. Left side close, but he's down inside right around the 2-yard line. So second down and goal. This is the formation that this team will run when they go short yardage,
yeah.
Especially inside the 5. They'll go really old school.
Old school. T. Not single wing, but T, the T formation.
Yep. And they're going to go to a little offset look now. Barnes. And he is met for a loss. Great pursuit.
Runs.
And this is Kashawn Robinson that's up there, number 2.
Yep, and I think Taylor had a part of that.
Yep.
And watch the edge here. Boom, there's Taylor, jumps outside the block. Look at that. There's 4 or 5 black jerseys around that ball carrier. They got to go. Coach Roth was right. Attack them downhill. Every time they've tried to attack the edges, they've struggled.
So third and goal from the 4-yard line. Barnes is the only setback. Here he goes, left side. He'll bounce it out. Stiff arm, gets in. No, met at the goal line. Oh, yes, he is short. Wow, what a defensive play.
What? Robinson.
Wow.
I mean, this is his physical. Watch this right here. Bow. Stiff arm. I mean, that's some great camera work right there. I don't know if he got in or not. The official had a great view of it, though. My goodness.
All right. So they bring Ty Arnold in, number 14, at quarterback. He's 6'2", 200. But Barnes thought he was going to make it. Here we go. Fourth and goal.
Timeout.
Yep. Westinghouse wants a timeout.
Timeout, Westinghouse. They're first.
Yeah, Dante Green ran all the way down to the 5-yard line to get that timeout.
Let's watch this again. That's a nice job filling right there. Stringing it out. Tackle. Whack. Man. Oh, that ball was coming out. That was it. This defense absolutely thumps. They are fun to watch.
Yeah, good clean hit, too.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
On the football.
Yep. And down at the goal line, right? Usually you tackle guys, you want to tackle the legs, right? You run with your legs. But down in the goal line, you got to tackle high. You got to run through the upper body to make sure that ball doesn't get across the end line. And Robinson absolutely ran through the body right there. There's no doubt. And Barnes had to come off the field. He's wearing a big elbow brace there. Yep. on his arm. And I don't know if they were. I hope there was just adjustment to that and not anything else. Because I am absolutely loving the interaction between the defenders for the Bulldogs in that front seven running and hitting and how physical this Tigers backfield runs the ball. I mean, this is a great matchup.
Well, Barnes is going to be out for another play. Now, he had that elbow injury that kept him out for a middle part of the season, but he's been healthy. So Arnold again is in a quarterback. Do we just simply see a quarterback sneak here? He didn't make it. Second effort. Do they give it to him? No signal. There it is. No, still nothing yet. Yes. I think, yeah, there it is. That was as hesitant as a yes it was touchdown as I've ever seen.
Yeah, we got to see this one. I mean, it looks from here, like it looks like he falls in. It's just, you know, when does the forward progress stop? Like, when should the whistle be blown?
Yeah,
he's battling in there though. He's still moving forward. That's great second effort right there. Third effort and fourth effort too.
Second rushing touchdown of the season for Arnold, and the extra point from Isaac Carter would give them a 7-6 lead. The hold is down, and the kick is up and through. 5:09 left to go in the second quarter. The Tigers, with an impressive drive, take a 7-6 lead.
Stadium lights are going out. The bleachers are empty. The reason? No officials. When fans are disrespectful to the calls on the field and those who make them, it is a hard position to fill. Show your support for your PIAA officials by demonstrating respect. Let's all work together so the game is great for everyone.
What are these people running from? Nothing. They're running to watch Pennsylvania's Neighborhood on PCN, featuring Chester County. Experience the history and culture. Enjoy the meals and treats. Watch Pennsylvania's Neighborhood on PCN, Chester County, starting December 12th. PCN is everything Pennsylvania.
Stream this championship and more anytime, anywhere, on demand with PCN Select. Learn more at PCNTV.com. Boy, this is a good one, too. We've got a 7-6 game, the Tigers. Hey, how about going back to the decision?
Yep.
Remember, going for it on fourth down.
On the 26th.
At the 26th of your Westinghouse. But his defense, Dante Green, nearly got it done.
Yeah, no, look, he has faith in that defense. And they're playing really, really well. And, you know, I get it. But at the same time, look, being a defensive coordinator, like, I would have a tough time with that. That decision, right? You're putting me down there in a really, really bad spot against a really nice offense.
Isaac Carter to kick this one off deep. This will be taken right around the 7-yard line by Westinghouse, and they'll bounce it out to the near side. Nice ankle tackle, trip down. I think that was Murphy that made the play.
Yeah, and it's a good thing, because looked like Sincere Smith was getting around the corner there. Right here, you can see him break down and just lay out and clip the heels. Doesn't take much sometimes.
20 Jeff Jervis on the tackle.
So from the 18-yard line, here comes the offense.
First and 10 of the 18.
Looks like Khalil Taylor's back in the backfield with Keyshawn Marcillo. Taylor's got the lone touchdown, and this will be Marcillo's straight quarterback run again, left side bouncing out, hurtling over one defender, and he'll fall forward to the 25-yard line, Marcillo gain of about seven.
Right, it's a nice run. He's been effective. That's 63 yards rushing right there. That's solid for a quarterback. Again, that's one of the things that, you know, during warm-ups, Coach Ross said, they got to handle the quarterback run today. There's a little quick trap again inside. There's a little quick hitter trying to get vertical, trying to get inside against a penetrating defense.
Oh, here we go. It's third down and short. They bring in the bigger body, Sean Robinson, the 5'9", 215-pound senior number five. He was in the last possession. He and Taylor will bounce around. Sometimes they'll put Robinson in as that lead back on short yard. It's just third down and one. Marcillo going to throw deep over the middle. He's got a receiver there and just missed the intended receiver, which was Sincere Smith, who had a step on the defender, Tuzelewski. And Madden, it looked like. Oh, it was Wozlowski that covered him.
Yeah, Marcellus missed on a couple here. It's good protection. Wozlowski in coverage. And Sincere Smith definitely had him. Again, that ball, they're just not quite connecting right now on those deep shots.
Bulldogs will be forced to punt. Wozlowski lets this one bounce, and it takes a Bulldog bounce, and it'll be down inside the 40-yard line, down to the 36. So the Tiger defense gave up a touchdown drive on a Taylor 22-yard run on Westinghouse's second possession, but has come up stout the last couple of series. Now let's see if this offense can continue to do what they did the last one. And that was a short field to get a touchdown.
Yeah, definitely. Look, this defense is playing really, really well for the Bulldogs, and they've made it difficult for the Tigers offense to march down the field a long ways. You know, Southern Columbia took advantage of a bold move by Coach Green and capitalized on it.
Carter Madden on the jet sweep. He'll go left side, try to get the corner, nowhere to go. And this is a challenge to try to run, I guess, east and west, basically, on this defense. You just can't do it.
No, you're not going to. They're trying to sneak one around there on the jet sweep. And this defense just runs so well.
Stop at number three, Busa Bengora.
Bengora with a nice play out there on the edge, stringing it out.
No gain, second down and 10. Barnes is back in the game,
which is good.
Wozlowski with the carry.
Oh boy.
And a trap, and he's got a lot of room. Inside the 40. A little sidestep move at the 35-yard line. Continues to go down the far sideline and taken down inside the 20. What a run by 24.
Wow. I mean, that was incredible. Little sweep, pops it upside. Great cut right there. I mean, here at the end, like, how does he get out of this? Oop, jumps back. Huge. I mean, look. It's a 46-yard run, and the last 10-15 was him dancing around. That is amazing. That's a heck of an effort.
First and 10 from the 18. Gain of a couple down to the 16-yard line. Gain of two, second and eight. That was Madden lined up in that offset, or that pro set, right.
Well, like I said, one of the things that the wing T does, right, there's usually a coach that kind of watches each spot and each position on defense, and they kind of give reports to each other, and they talk, and they go, well, this is what's going to work now with what they're doing.
Jet sweep again. Wozlowski, nowhere to go, met in the backfield. Looks like they're going to give him the original line of scrimmage.
That's going to be a tough one to pull off. I'd put that one away if I were Coach Roth. Watch O'Neal right here, number seven, come up from his safety spot.
Third down.
Great tackle. These guys are tackling really well. That's really, like I said in the open, you know, tackle. Be where you're supposed to be and tackle. And for the most part, that's exactly what this Bulldogs defense is doing. You saw on that really long run by Wislowski, they missed some tackles as it went on. But yeah, tackling talented backs in space.
They're down and eight. Madden motion back. You're going to come counter near side. Back to Loudon Murphy. He'll gain a few inside the 15 down to the 12. But it's going to bring up a fourth down.
He stopped at number 15, Michael Christensen.
Murphy does a good job. A little change up there, getting that little counter. Right, third down, third and long. That's kind of the go-to in the wing tee. It's their little counter play, and you get everything flowing one way and bring it back, the other wing back underneath. They run it really, really well.
Looks like they're going to let this one run down and take a timeout if you're Southern Columbia.
Talk about it a little bit.
Timeout, Southern Columbia, they're first.
Now we can discuss, what do you run here?
I would give it, I mean, Wislowski or Barnes, one or the other in some way, shape, or form. And again, they've had a lot of success getting between the tackles, shoulder pads square. I would definitely stay away from the jet sweep.
Yep.
Which at this point hasn't gotten them very many yards, but yeah, they're going to try and attack between the tackles. I mean, this is a tough call. This is not a gimme down, right? This is not fourth and two.
Right.
It's not fourth and one. The way that this Bulldogs defense runs, you know, this is a gamble. It may be worth kicking a field goal if your guy can do it. You know what I mean? Get the points.
Well, they have not had a successful field goal all season.
Yeah.
And Isaac Carter is a soccer player.
And a D tackle. Which is amazing. Maybe my favorite
something.
Thing.
That, right. We can try to talk about that a little bit more.
Crazy.
But I was going to say, you try to go off tackle to the field, but that last bar, here's the field goal.
Oh.
Here we go. You're right. They're going to kick it from the 20-yard line. So a 30-yard field goal for Isaac Carter. First field goal attempt of the season. He got it. Nope.
No.
He missed it.
It looked good from here.
Yes, it did.
This is going just outside that.
So Carter's a soccer player. Let's take a look at this.
Yeah, here we go. It's coming up. I mean, it's just. Ooh, outside or on top of the. I guess that's right. Yep, right there. You see that it's just outside that right upright.
Wow. So Carter is a soccer player that when his soccer season ended, week 10, he told Coach Roth, hey, I'd like to play. They moved him, they put him at defensive tackle. Coach Roth said it's like he was there for 10 weeks.
Yep. Yeah, it's been a lot of, that's kind of a cool, not one you hear about much, the kicker slash DT.
A disruptive force for sure. Let's see if they can get a stop here. Here's Marcillo, straight up the middle again on a quarterback draw. And I think you're going to see Westinghouse play this conservative. We'll have to see. Maybe not. They've been able to stretch the field vertically a couple of times. Just missed on the combination.
Yeah, if Marcillo hits on one of those.
Taylor's in the backfield. He'll throw. Screen set up. Complete to Taylor. And he'll get enough for the first down to the 35-yard line.
Timeout.
Pass complete to number 9, Khalil Taylor.
Fedorov was on the stop.
Timeout. Westinghouse. They're second of the half.
Now they can take a shot here. You got a little bit more breathing room at the 35-yard line.
Yeah, you know, look, you don't want to be too conservative here, right? Southern Columbia is going to get the football. It starts the second half. They deferred the first, so they're going to get the ball. Take a shot. Try and get the ball downfield. They have had guys run open. You know, you had, you know, early in the game, and Marcelo just missed by just a little bit on both of them. So they got to feel good about that matchup with their receivers against the defensive backs for Southern Columbia. The screen pass is a good call. You don't be surprised if you see a quarterback drawing here somewhere, too. You got one timeout left. You want to be smart with it. Southern Columbia is going to try and defend the outside of the field, right? Don't let you get out of bounds. Make sure you lay on guys when you tackle them. Slow things down. We'll sprint out here, maybe.
Four wide receivers, three topside. Taylor's in the backfield with Marcillo on first and 10. Here comes some pressure. Straight up the middle. Here's Marcillo. This is where he can be so dangerous. And he'll dance out of bounds at around the 42-yard line inside Tigers territory.
2 minute drive with a quarterback that can beat you with his feet is tough right there. And I don't know if that was a designed QB draw or not, but that was a great decision by Marcillo right there. And a good job working his way out of bounds after he got enough yards.
From the 42, 31 seconds to go in the second quarter. Marcillo to throw again. Here comes some more pressure. Penalty flag is down, so it looks like they're going to get
holding.
A holding penalty on Westinghouse. Carter was one of the guys who run him out, along with Fedorov, 32.
I think the initial pressure might have been Deal.
Holding. Offense, number 50. 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
Yeah, Harvey, the guard. He's come close a couple times, and I think he's working on Deal here. Can't tell who that is. He pulls him down right there. But, and right in front of the official.
So let's push the ball back all the way to the 42-yard line of Westinghouse. First and 26. Four wide receivers, three to the right of Marcillo.
Ouch.
Get a delay a game? Nope, timeout.
They had to burn their timeout because they were about to get a delay a game.
Timeout, Westinghouse, their final timeout.
That's tough right there. That operational, right, you know, procedural football, right? You get the holding, and now you burn the whole clock and you have to use your last timeout so you don't get another penalty and push yourself 5 yards further from the end zone. What looked like a real promising drive by the Bulldogs right there after that QB draw or that scramble by Marcillo. Now they've gone backwards again and they've burned their last timeout. So now they've got to work the sideline. Mm-hmm. Now they've got to keep the ball outside, which again, if you're Southern Columbia, you know that, right? So defend the boundary and tackle anything that comes up the middle.
So if you have a quarterback draw, as long as you keep him in check,
yeah.
Screen pass isn't going to happen because that's a play in between.
Yep.
You're probably not going to do that. So let's see what they decide to do. Sincere Smith is the only receiver to this near side, number 8. Three receivers to the right of Marcillo. And again, Khalil Taylor is in the backfield. Four down linemen for Southern Columbia. This one complete inside the 40.
And they'll take it, right? That's not a first down. The clock isn't going to stop.
Devon Jones with the reception.
Right, you got 14 seconds. You probably just want to snap it and down it. And do that under center for you.
So the 40-yard line is the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
That'll be...
So it's third down. You don't have timeouts. You got 9 seconds left. Take a shot, and then go into the locker room at halftime and be really happy with where you are right now.
Four wide receivers, two on either side for Marcillo. Now penalty flag. Looks like it's going to be on Westinghouse again.
False start. Offense, number 1. 5-yard penalty, still Ooh, third down.
Receiver, Blackwell. That's a no-no. You see him right there on the hash at the top of your screen, top left corner. You saw him moving. He thought he was going in motion.
So he's lined up in a slot, same spot. Smith, near side, down at the bottom of your screen. Motion again, same play coming from Westinghouse. Now 3 to the right. Marcillo looking left, flushed out of the pocket. Here comes the pressure. Isaac Carter trying to chase him down, and they'll get him down to the 35-yard line.
Flag.
And a penalty flag,
a
so we will get one more play. Another flag. So if this is on Westinghouse, however, this could be offsetting. The first one's going to be a late hit.
Definitely.
That was clear.
Yep, so you see Marcelo here. Great pressure, great coverage on the back end. You see the pressure. Marcelo gets outside the pocket. Right, Fedorov goes for the tackle, and right there, I think that's Carter right there that comes in. Yep, the kicker D-tackle, and then the quarterback gets up, and Marcelo's mad, and everybody's pushing each other.
It was sending Southern Columbia off the field, so I'd have to imagine it's offsetting. It looks like the coaching staffs are going to meet for a moment. I'll let this thing settle down before we throw it to our halftime show. Make sure we get this clear. But the Tigers are heading toward the end zone. Jim Roth, Dante Green, getting the explanation. I mean, the concern I would have here is if a punch was thrown.
Yeah, it got a little...
That would be
jumbled up over there,
because then we're going to have a player ejected.
You think maybe offsetting, right?
I mean, that's what I imagine.
There was the third flag, though, wasn't there?
Yeah, there was. Yeah.
The third flag is the one that's, I'm not certain, right? You had the late hit by Southern Columbia, by Carter. Then you had Marcelo get up and go after him. So there's a personal foul. And then the third flag is the one that, I don't know. But Westinghouse is officially off the field. Southern Columbia is in the corner of the end zone. Yep, somebody came flying in there.
Kind of like, we'd like to get an explanation here.
Stop! Stop, man! Oh, not another one!
Here we go.
There are fouls on multiple teams. Dead ball, personal foul, 54, White. Dead ball, personal foul, 53, White. Dead ball, personal foul, number 4, Black. We will enforce 15 yards on the second half kickoff. The half is over.
All right, there we go. There's where all three flags went.
Wow.
All right, 7-6 at the half, Southern Columbia. Stay tuned. Mike Zambelli, Jim Wills take you through halftime.
Because. Two syllables, 7 letters, so much meaning. Because is an explanation, an answer to the question why. It connects where we've been to where we're going. And at Highmark, the road ahead is altogether new. We are reinventing healthcare because it can be simpler, smoother, because it can do more. Get ready for healthcare that goes beyond care. Because life. Highmark, Blue Shield.
It doesn't matter what part of the state you're from. One thing is certain. Pennsylvania loves sports. On the first Friday of the month, PCN takes you inside the lines at 6:30 p.m. PCN delivers insight from the people who cover sports from every corner of the Commonwealth. From high school to college to professional sports, PCN takes you inside the lines. Learn more at PCNTV.com.
All right, now listen up. You've got a job to do at the Farm Show. You've got to represent PCN. You have what you need. The PCN logo on your back, and you're squishy. So when a visitor comes to the PCN booth, you jump into their hand. Who's with me? That's right. Conserve your energy. Go get them.
The Pennsylvania Farm Show, starting January 7th.
I officiate PIAA sports, and I am an accountant.
I officiate PIAA sports, and I'm a teacher.
I'm a PIAA basketball official, I'm a firefighter, I'm a father, and I'm also a fan. I think it's easy for people to forget that we are regular people, that the same people that I'm refereeing, that my kids plays with those kids sometimes. My kids play in the same league as these kids.
One of the greatest aspects of officiating is building relationships with the partners you're working games with, getting to know them as people, also building relationships with the players and the coaches that are on the field with you every game.
These kids work so hard day in and day out, and you get to watch the benefit of them getting a new personal record, them making that bar that they've been dreaming of for weeks, and you get to have a front row seat to witness that every single day.
Halftime at our 2A championship game from Cumberland Valley High School, and what a defensive battle this has turned out to be. Southern Columbia with a one-point lead over Westinghouse, the difference in the game, a missed extra point. We welcome you back to our halftime show. Mike Zambelli, pleased to be joined by Jim Wills. Jim, I think we have to start right away with a decision by Dante Green to go for it on fourth down and about four from his own 27-yard line. It'll be a decision that'll be talked about, and you and I were discussing it. Hey, I don't have a problem with him going with it. What did you think about using the arm of Marcillo rather than his legs to go for it on fourth down?
And I think if he had to do that over again, Mike, he would say, we want to run the football with our quarterback. The thing of it is, you know, it was 4 yards they needed, but the thing of it is, the way he runs the ball, I think a quarterback keeper or a quarterback draw would have been a better play.
And you and I have talked about a lot of times, you get in these environments, hey, you swing the bat, you swing for the fences, you try and win these games, so you don't really have a problem with it there. The other thing, I think he showed great confidence in his defense as well, which nearly came up with a stop to keep them out of the end zone. They have three stops inside the 20 or inside the red zone already in the football game.
Yeah, that forced a fourth and one that, you know, fortunately for Southern Columbia, they got it in with a different quarterback. But the thing of it is, you're right, the defense almost pulled it off for him, and he does have a lot of confidence in his defense, which has played a whale of a first half.
Well, they certainly have. We'll take a look at that in just a moment, but let's dial up some highlights for Southern Columbia, and of course, their outstanding running back in Braden Wislowski, and of course, a two-way performer, and a beautiful job there playing a flanker screen, and of course, his ability to run between the tackles and churn for extra yards. He does such a good job of finishing off runs, and those are his numbers. Over 100 yards rushing already in his first half.
Yeah, and 11 carries. He's really been strong, and the thing of it is that when they got him into that second level, he's been very productive as well. You can see here he gets to the outside. They haven't got to the outside very many times here this afternoon, but when he gets to the outside, he's been very productive. But it's his bruising ability. This run right here just shows you his whole afternoon. You're going to see a lot of different things here, a skip, a hop, and then he's going to do a spin move. He put it all in one run there and got himself a couple more yards down the field. He did an outstanding job in that run. That run right there signifies the way he's been playing today.
Yeah, he confused the GPS and the circuit there, that's for sure. Anything but a direct route. So over 100 yards rushing for him against the defense. And, you know, one of the things we were discussing prior to the game, how difficult it is to prepare against that wing T offense when you don't see it all year long. You have guys that are trying to simulate it in practice, and it's very difficult to do. I thought they did a tremendous job in that first half defensively.
Well, I think one of the things that they have in their favor is their speed. And you can see the way they're going to close on people here all the time. Those guys that have been in the defensive back position have done an outstanding job, whether it be Robinson, number two, whether it be you know, O'Neal, number seven, Cahill Taylor, who scored a touchdown. All those guys have been coming up quick from their spots. You saw another one right there by Marsilio. All those guys have been able to come up quickly and shut things down. And when you have speed like that, sometimes it doesn't matter what offense they're running because they can match it whatever they can with that speed. Now here, this is where they've gotten really, really tough on the goal line. They tried to, you know, get a swing to the outside there, and getting on the outside has been really, really hard. This hit right here is going to be a monster. That is the way you need to hit people, and that was from Keshawn Robinson.
Well, Brandon Noble talked about it. We discussed it with him. Of course, he's a defensive guy. You know, you get penetration up the field, and, you know, certainly Westinghouse did a very good job of that. The other thing I thought Brandon did a really good job of explaining was that touchdown for Southern Columbia. I'm sure the Westinghouse people are saying forward progress was stopped, but watch it. They never stopped moving the pile forward. I thought the officials did a good job there. Forward progress never stopped, and that was appropriately called a touchdown on fourth down.
Yeah, very good job by the officials, and that's what it is. Keep your feet moving. Mm-hmm. Keep the pile moving, and they did, and they got success with it.
We've got more to come at the half. We'll take a look back to yesterday's results, a couple of highlights from last night's game, and take a look at what lies ahead on Championship Weekend. Stay with us.
Cat day, house plan day, pirate-themed half-birthday.
Second Tuesday of September.
Football party's all November.
Blue Mockingbird migration.
Swimming lesson, graduation.
Jeff paid his parking ticket.
Kevin found his guinea pig.
With Wise, entertaining is so easy, you'll have to find new reasons to celebrate. Wing trays, grilling essentials, and desserts, only at Wise.
Glitter day.
PCN is more than your favorite shows. We're the dedicated people, your friends and neighbors who create those shows and bring them to you. We offer high quality coverage of public affairs, politics, sports, and history of our Commonwealth. Every day we bring the best of Pennsylvania to your home and mobile device. With your donation to PCN, you can help us continue to bring these shows to you. To find out more, visit our website at pcntv.com. PCN is people. Love our Pennsylvania's Neighborhood series? Here's a look at where we've already been. Visit PCNTV.com to watch on demand now or purchase copies of your favorite locations. PCN, we are Pennsylvania's Neighborhood.
PCN brings the distinct aspects of Pennsylvania and its residents to your favorite screen.
Hear from state government and community leaders during unedited, balanced coverage of politics and policy.
Dig into the rich history and culture of the state, presented by notable residents and historians.
Score a view of the best high school, college, and world-class athletes competing across the state, and much, much more.
Start exploring the Keystone State today on PCN and the PCN app. A huge party is coming, and you're invited. In 2026, America will celebrate 250 years as a nation. Now through 2026, watch PCN for special programming. Join us as we highlight Pennsylvania's contributions to the founding of our nation with Celebrating America's 250th in Pennsylvania. For more information, go to PCNTV.com. PCN is everything Pennsylvania. PCN is Pennsylvania history and culture. From the founding of our nation to the struggle for freedom and equality. Listen to the words of authors as they discuss Pennsylvania and the people, places, and events that relate to the Commonwealth. Celebrate our diversity. Embrace the past as we look to the future and be a part of building our nation. PCN is Pennsylvania history and culture.
7-6, Southern Columbia looking to continue their winning ways in this environment with a one-point lead in this, the AA championship game. We welcome you back to part two of our halftime show. Again, Mike Zambelli, Jim Wills. Jim, a very intriguing first day with Steelton knocking off Union 22-8 to win their fourth title. And last night, Bishop McDevitt 41, Aliquippa 18. We'll dial up some highlights of that one for you here. And what a performance by Stone Saunders and Tyshawn Russell. This is the first of four hookups between the two of those.
Yeah, he did a nice job last night. And then you get to come up with an interception here by Aliquippa. Now, Saunders did throw some interceptions, but the thing of it is, Aliquippa's speed came into play here, as you're going to see Brandon Brooks come up with that interception.
Brooks with a beautiful play. Not only got 1 foot down, but got two of them down. Would have been good on a Sunday call. Terrific effort on his part. Aliquippa then would turn that turnover into some points the other way. Quentin Good finding Cameron Lindsay here, extending the play and into the end zone for 6 points for Aliquippa. And certainly it was game on at this point between these two.
Yeah, it was pretty even at this point, Mike. And then Bishop McDevitt's going to come up with an interception here. Good didn't have a good night sometimes, and this is one of the things that did not go well for him right there, as you're going to see Ty Kephart come up with the interception right here. Did a great job of taking that for the distance.
And that would set up another Saunders to Russell. They really had what they wanted there. Just a beautiful post pattern and into the end zone for yet another touchdown.
And you're going to see here Riley Roble, who had a heck of a night here with a strip sack, comes up with the football right there.
You know, with all the offense, there were a lot of folks that felt that number 55 was the player of the game last night. That strip sack and fumble recovery, one of a number of key plays he made. Saunders then able to find Rico Scott for the touchdown, and McDevitt really started to take control of the football game at this point.
And again, you're going to see they did not have an answer all night for him as he went inside again. The big guy at 6'3", 300 pounds, just dominated that middle.
Brennan Allman coming up with that loose football that time, and you and I were standing right there on that dime that he dropped in to the bucket for Russell. That was the third hookup and touchdown for those two.
Yeah, that was one of the best plays of the night, and that was an absolutely beautiful put pass in that corner. He couldn't have put it anywhere but where he put it.
Saunders once again, and there is that same pattern. Aliquippa never able to make the adjustment, and the route was necessarily on at that time. But Aliquippa is a team riding a 24-game win streak, and you mentioned they had some interceptions, and here's John Tracy with a pick six. Guy who did a good job rushing the football, also did a good job defensively.
Yeah, they come up with a couple good interceptions here, and you're going to see another one come up here. And, you know, the fact is that Saunders threw a couple of them here. As well as he played offensively on some spots, there were some spots that he got intercepted with, and then you're going to see Donovan Walker come up with one here.
Tyke Hayes has had a terrific career for Aliquippa. He's only a youngster. Look at him pull through would-be defenders there, and the strength to get the football into the end zone. You got to like the way that the Quips continued to battle up till the end. That set up a sneak by Quentin Good for the touchdown, but it was all coming a little too late for the Quips.
And then Marquise Williams, the recruit out of Minnesota, shows you why he's going to be going to that university. What a big-time run right here as he goes upfield, does an excellent job of getting himself in great position.
Williams is going to finish what he started here as he finds pay dirt once again as McDevitt goes on to win by a final of 41-18. Head coach Jeff Wechter gets his state championship in 5 tries. He's now 1-4 in the championship game. Both teams ending the year at 13-1. And of course, the Quips saw their state high at this point of the season, 24-game winning streak, come to a close. But a terrific first day here at Cumberland Valley High School.
Yeah, you couldn't ask for better action. We've had some great games. The first game with Union and Steel High was a great game. And then the game last night, obviously, got away from the Quips at the end. But mm-hmm. Boy, for a half, it was very, very competitive. And Stone Saunders took over with all those touchdowns. Passes.
Looking for a big second half here in this RAA championship game. Doug Heater, Brandon Noble will take us home. Stay with us. You are watching the PIAA football championships live on the Pennsylvania Cable Network.
PCN understands the importance of working hard in the field.
So this winter, get ready for 2 great events live on PCN. In December, catch the PIAA High School Football Championships live December 8th, 9th, and 10th.
Then in January, it's a week of the Pennsylvania Farm Show. Around-the-clock coverage with live and recorded events on PCN and PCN Select starting January 7th.
live PIAA Championship Football.
And the Pennsylvania Farm Show on PCN. PCN is everything Pennsylvania.
What are these people running from? Nothing. They're running to watch Pennsylvania's Neighborhood on PCN, featuring Chester County. Experience the history and culture. Enjoy the meals and treats. Watch Pennsylvania's Neighborhood on PCN, Chester County, starting December 12th. PCN is everything Pennsylvania.
Welcome back to Chapman Field on the campus of Cumberland Valley High School. Second half about set to get underway between Southern Columbia and Westinghouse. Doug Heater along with Brandon Noble. And I'd ask you, who's got an advantage? I mean, we've got a gutsy fourth down call that didn't work for Westinghouse, but they're a missed extra point from this being a tie ball game. But they've got to believe, I mean, if there was anybody that doubted that these guys belonged or weren't going to be able to stand toe-to-toe with a physical Southern Columbia team, they are not doubting that anymore.
Yeah, no doubt. And they're the Westinghouse team, you come out, you've never been here before. You know, this program's really just been rebuilt. And you played, basically gone toe-to-toe with, mm-hmm. with the champ.
Yeah.
Right for a half. So you got to feel really good about that. Southern Columbia is going to get the football first. Defensively, you've got to come out and you've got to be ready to go. Don't let Southern Columbia establish that run because
yep.
they're going to make adjustments, right? Jim Roth's group is going to make adjustments. That's what wing T teams do. And so they've got to be able to continue to keep the intensity and the level of violence that they're playing with defensively right now, because I'm loving that, absolutely loving it.
This has been a real great game so far. Let's take a look at the first half numbers between these two teams. And you see passing has been at a premium. Just 1 for 3 for Southern Columbia, 3 for 9 for Keyshawn Morcillo and his Westinghouse team, 9 and 10 passing yards. Now, listen, Southern Columbia had over 300 rushing yards last week. But it's been ground game, ground game, ground game for both of these teams. I don't know if that changes much here in the second half.
No. I think I wouldn't be surprised to see Westinghouse maybe try and take another shot. They had a couple opportunities with the slot receivers running down the field. But look, Southern Columbia is going to run the football. And I think that they've gone in and, again, make adjustments, stop killing ourselves with false starts, and don't get behind the sticks, right? Run the ball between the tackles. That's the recipe for success for the Tigers.
One of the things Jim Roth talked about also, and there hasn't been, is a turnover. He said that's been huge for his team over the course of these last four games in the playoffs. You know, in a game like this where it's so close, that could potentially be what hinges whether you win or lose this game.
Yeah, turnovers, big plays, kicking game, right? And right now you've got a missed extra point that's the difference in the football game. It's been clean from a turnover perspective. Penalties can become an issue. You saw it got a little messy there at the end of the half. I'm sure both coaches addressed that. But this has been a really good football game first half, and I'm expecting the same in the second.
What do you think Dante Green told his team?
Keep doing what you're doing. Keep swinging, man. Keep chopping away at those guys, and eventually that ball is going to come out. They have absolutely punished running backs. It's been a lot of fun to watch.
Yeah, this has been a physical team, that's for sure. And again, this is the first time in 105-year school history that this team, this school, Westinghouse, has been in the state playoffs. And this is a team, this is a city league that has not had a state representative in a representative in the state finals in 25 years. They've only had one team ever win a state championship, and Perry Academy did it in 1989. So, second half about to get underway. And as Jim Roth told me earlier this week, he said, you never know what can happen in the first half. So you want to get the ball and get things going in the second half. So they'll do that. There's Braden Wozlowski, who has been a key contributor on the offensive side here today. He's one of the guys back deep to return for Southern Columbia.
The workhorse. He's fun to watch run the football. The battle between the Southern Columbia backfield and the linebackers and safeties and DNs for this Bulldogs defense has been really, really fun to watch. I mean, this is old-time football right here.
We had a play at the goal line. We had a near goal line stand on fourth down. Ty Arnold has the only touchdown for Southern Columbia in this game on a one-yard sneak, his second rushing touchdown of the season. And he's brought in as that bigger body quarterback. So because of the penalty, if you weren't here with us at the end of the second quarter, we had three separate penalties, two on Southern Columbia. So the Bulldogs will kick off from the 45. Let's see. I thought maybe did they try to onside it? They do not. Wislowski takes it at the 10-yard line, kind of dancing forward to the 20, and they'll run him out of bounds right around there at the 20-yard line.
It'll be interesting to see kind of what adjustments this offensive staff made at halftime. You know, again, and by adjustments, like, you know, where are we going to attack? You know, they've kind of been outside, inside. They're met, you know, the counter coming back has been effective. The kind of the dive and the quick hitters up the middle. And you want to get into a rhythm here, and they really want to put a nice drive together here, control the clock, run the football, and get some points.
Barnes the only back in the backfield for Blake Wise. Here's Barnes left side. Not much to go. Maybe a gain of two. We'll give him 2 yards up to the 23-yard line with the original line of scrimmage at the 21, so it's second down and 8.
And these cats are filling.
Yes.
I think that was O'Neal. Tamir O'Neal from his safety spot again, you know, coming flying up. And he's doing a good job. It seems to me that he is mirroring the fullback. He is mirroring Barnes. You know, he seems to be there every time Barnes tries to get off tackle.
This is Loudon Murphy spinning forward up to the 30-yard line. It'll bring up a third down and short, about a yard and a half. They're just inside the 30. Sorry, this is Wislowski.
Wislowski, nice block there by Barnes up front, clearing the way for Wislowski.
Third down and a long one. First possession of the second half for Southern Columbia. The Tigers under the legend Jim Roth looking for their sixth consecutive and 13th overall state championship. Pro set right. They'll run right up the middle.
Man.
Nowhere to go. Boy, they filled that hole again. Maybe back to the line of scrimmage at the 30-yard line. It'll bring up a fourth down.
There he is again, number 7, O'Neal. He's been super active and physical. Man, he is absolutely punishing running backs today. This is a huge stop right there. Again, you know, Southern Columbia defers. They want to get into a rhythm. You want to get the ball coming out in the second half and kind of start fast and finish the game that way. That's a huge stop right there.
Isaac Carter to punt. This will take a favorable Westinghouse roll inside the 40. They'll down it at the 30-yard line, at the 38-yard line. Ryan Kerstetter down there.
I'm really for Westinghouse. It's really been Morcillo more than anything else, more than Khalil Taylor. You know, running the football and hurting this Southern Columbia defense with his legs. And he's missed a couple big shots down the field. But it's really been the designed quarterback run and the off-schedule run where he's kind of making something happen when he's throwing the football.
First and 10 from the 39. Here's Morcillo again with nowhere to go. And that's Colton Bloom, number 31, that comes up and steps up the defensive end to kind of set that edge. They'll lose some yards.
A little QB trap almost there. Just pulled a guard. Tigers were ready for that one.
Loss of 2, second down and 12. It's been all running today so far. Here's Taylor, again, nowhere to go. Arnold's one of the players in there. Fedorov is there as well.
Fedorov, Arnold, again, penetration. Knocking people backwards.
Third down.
Southern Columbia defense been playing lights out also. You know, we talked a lot about the Bulldogs so far and the way they're showing up, but this Southern Columbia defense is getting after it.
Third down and 15. Passing down for Westinghouse. First possession of the second half for the Bulldogs. Motion back is right. Here's Morsillo. Pump fake pressure coming by Fedorov. Deep down that sideline. Wislowski's there. And he'll knock it away.
Guys everywhere. I mean, he was, you know, showed some highlights at halftime of the game last year. And Wislowski was everywhere last year, too, on the defensive side of the ball. And here he is in coverage. Great job getting his eyes back around, turning for the football, and trying to go get it like he's playing offense right there.
So here comes a punt. Putting the sword away, too. Yes. I noticed that's the new, shtick. Got to put the sword away after you make the play. This is going to be a short field. This will take a favorable Westinghouse roll down to the 40-yard line. I tell you what, Brandon, I would not have expected this game to be basically field position at this point. Yeah. You know, but I knew these defenses were good. And I wouldn't have expected this at this point.
No, it's been really impressive. It's hard. These are two explosive offenses in different ways. You know, they do it differently. But you look at the Southern Columbia backs, right? They're averaging double digits yards per carry coming into this game. Right? It's been an absolute battle for every yard today.
First and 10, here's Wislowski after making that pass breakup. And boy, he had a nice run. That's a gain of close to six, up to the 46-yard line. He had that really nice run that set them up, that had that missed field goal when it just was amazing that he was able to dance away from so many tacklers.
Powerful, 5'11", 185 pounds, got great balance. He runs angry, right? He's a lot of, you know, big stiff arms, tries to run through people. But he's also got the kind of the niftiness and the agility. So I'd like to talk about that really long run at the end of the first half and bouncing around, making people miss.
There's Carter Madden this time. He'll get up to the 50-yard line. This is going to be awfully close, maybe enough to get the first down. Oh, this is Barnes that's in there. Barnes was nicked up earlier in the game. He came back. He's got that big elbow pad.
Big elbow pass, just a little iso, a little lead on the backside. Great block up front, getting Wislowski. That O-line moving people off the ball. Move the sticks.
First and 10. Wislowski in motion, he'll get it. Here comes the counter. This is Madden, the near side. Dances away from one tackler. A gain of close to seven, maybe eight, down to the 42-yard line inside Westinghouse territory.
Really, really nice cut right there by Madden. They haven't been able to get that jet sweep around. And they run it a little different this time with that counter. Really nice cut right there getting vertical, because that Westinghouse defense did a great job of setting the edge, but he was able to put his foot in the ground, go vertical. Really the first time he's gotten around the corner on this defense.
Second down and two. Wislowski, a little slow jet sweep motion, stiff arm, and they'll drag him down. But there's that extra effort. It's enough. Fumble. The ball's out. Westinghouse has recovered it, if they call this a fumble.
There it is.
And there it is. There's our first turnover of the game.
And, you know, when you run the ball like Wislowski does, that kind of stuff happens, right? When you're always battling for that extra effort, that extra yard.
It's a fumble. Recovered by Westinghouse.
So it's first Michael down. Richardson that tore it out of there. Yep.
Pops out. Ball's on the group.
Westinghouse takes over first and 10. 142.
So a big break as this Southern Columbia offense was really starting to move consistently.
Turnovers are huge. And we saw it last night in the game with McDevitt and Aliquippa. And, you know, the points off of turnovers can change things.
First and 10 from the 42. Hand off to Taylor. He dances in the backfield, makes a tackler miss, and he'll gain close to eight up to the 50-yard line midfield.
Nice block right there on the edge. Number five, Robinson, the tailback, kind of fullback guy.
Yeah, this is more of their heavy look now. They've got Morsillo under center. And here's Robinson, the bulldozer, and he'll gain the necessary yards. So both of these teams trying to showcase some power running. They'll spot this at the 45-yard line in Southern Columbia territory.
Reward him for the nice block on the last play right there, Sean Robinson. Hand him the football.
UPMC is proud to support PCN's live coverage of the PIAA football championships. Here's a run on first down to the 40-yard line. They are sponsoring this year's Score Bar. UPMC is committed to treating and preventing sports injuries in student athletes. UPMC, life-changing medicine. A gain of close to five. Let's give him four. Now a flag is down.
Well, when Taylor was getting up, he pushed the guy that tackled him. Like, I don't understand. You gotta control yourself a little bit. Again, you don't know what's going on down there, but it was Khalil Taylor.
After the play, dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct. Westinghouse, number 9. 15 yards from the end of the run, it'll be second down.
You see, it's a nice run, right? Good job. Fedorov comes off, makes the tackle. And he gets up and gives him a little.
Yep.
You know, you got to control your. Football's an emotional game, but you got to learn how to control them. Snap the whistle, do what you want. After that, you got to keep it clean. Because these are the kind of things, again, you've got a great opportunity with a turnover. Now you're looking at second and a million.
Second and 21, here's that heavy look again. Morcillo running behind those two big backs. He'll get inside Southern Columbia territory. Hoy is there, number 6, along with Tuzelewski.
Morcillo's really been the best weapon for this Westinghouse offense. That QB run, again, there's a little QB lead or QB ISO, whatever you want to call it, off that right side. Morcillo gets around the edge and gets him back to, I mean, look, it's still third and very long.
A little bit more manageable.
Well, now it's definitely more manageable.
Are you, depending on what we see here, four downs, do we think? I mean,
I don't know. I don't think so. I mean, look, he went
too early.
He went for it on the 26 coming out. So,
yeah.
I mean, yes, maybe Coach Green feels pretty good about it, but I would punt and try and pin Southern Columbia.
Here's Morcillo to throw. Here comes pressure. Is that Arnold? Off the edge. It's Loudon Murphy, 26. They brought some pressure on a big quarterback sack.
Heat him up. I like it right there. Just bringing 6 off the edge, loss of 9, huge sack. Loudon Murphy, untouched off the edge. That's a freebie right there.
That's coming from the safety position. And on a predictable passing down, you're able to do that. So fourth down, here comes a punt. Line drive, Wislowski lets it bounce. He'll take it on a couple hops. And he's got a seam up the middle.
Oh.
And he'll take it inside the 45-yard line. They're going to spot this around the 43. We're going to step aside. 7-6, 4:19 to go in the third quarter from Cumberland Valley High School.
A huge party is coming, and you're invited. In 2026, America will celebrate 250 years as a nation. Now through 2026, watch PCN for special programming. Join us as we highlight Pennsylvania's contributions to the founding of our nation with Celebrating America's 250th in Pennsylvania. For more information, go to PCNTV.com. PCN is everything Pennsylvania.
All of us question why we're here, what are we supposed to do with our lives, but when I am at work, it all makes sense. You really can make an impact in people's lives. Being kind and empathetic and caring, sometimes it's just nice to do a small thing to make someone feel human.
At Cumberland Valley High School. What a game here in the 2A championship. Southern Columbia, 7. Westinghouse, 6. 4:19 to go. The Tigers just got a big stop on a big sack play by Loudon Murphy to force a punt. And now great field position on the return.
It's kind of sacrilege, but maybe take a shot here.
Yeah, quick turn or quick change. They're going to hand off inside the Barnes. That's a pretty good run.
Yeah.
Close to 5 yards inside the 40 down to the 38.
Early downs are tough on a defense versus the wing T. You know, first and second down, second especially in this spot right here. Look at that spin, man. This guy just runs so hard. It's an opportunity to maybe take a shot. I know it's not what they do, and they don't want to do it. Coach Ross said they're not going to pick the ball up and throw it, but at the end of the day, you might have an opportunity.
This is Wislowski, and he'll get close to returning to the line of scrimmage, but about a half a yard short, so a little bit of a loss back to the 38-yard line. Loss of one. It's going to bring up a third down and five.
This defense is running to the football. I mean, and that's what I'm saying. Like, the opportunity to throw the ball might be there because they have everybody in the box. They don't have a safety beyond. I mean, everybody's within 3 yards of the line of scrimmage for the most part, unless they're playing a split end and it's a corner and they're outside. But they have everybody in the box.
Chrisman's lined up at the bottom of your screen. And here's a handoff to Wislowski again. There he goes. He will score untouched from the 38-yard line, and Southern Columbia will extend this lead. It's funny you bring that point up, Brandon, because Jim Roth said that if they start bringing the box and we can hit those quick hitters, we can get to that second level.
Yep, and that's exactly what they did there. And one of the things about this run game, too, is that, you know, you just keep chopping away at it. That's run to perfection right there by Wislowski. Great job up front by the offensive line, the backs blocking. And then Wislowski finishes it. And those 2, 3, 4 yard gains eventually turn into 15, 20 yard gains because you start wearing the defense out. And as physical as this group has played, right, it's a long day to play against a wing tee offense like this.
They are going 4-2. Barnes, the only setback. And we're going to get a whistle to stop play.
Timeout. Southern Columbia, they're first.
So the theory here is to go up 9, obviously forcing them to score twice. You know, it's a given. I would have to believe, even if they were to miss the extra point, that based on the kicking game for Westinghouse, that they're going to go, they would go for the lead the next time they score. So why not try this? Especially with the way they just scored there with Wislowski. That's rushing touchdown number 25 on the season for a guy that averages 120 yards per game and over 12 yards per carry.
That was a great run right there. He had the great run at the end of this first half. But this defense has done a really good job because he's earned every bit of it today. That's, 151 yards today, and he's going to feel every one of those tomorrow. This when you're 17, you bounce back pretty quick, though.
So Barnes in the backfield. Murphy wing back right. Wislowski left. There he goes in motion. Fake Wise will keep it, or is this Arnold? He's in. Two-pointer's good.
Something
it's
a little
Arnold.
Different. Yeah, a little wrinkle right there. A little wrinkle.
So 15-6, so now two possessions is what Westinghouse will need.
This big punt return right here, right? That was huge. He didn't really want to pick that up, but it kind of, Christmas. Oh, man, a nice little run by Barnes right there, a little spin, gets things going, and then here it comes right here, Wislowski rewarded for your efforts. Great block by Barnes right there. That was the key. The block by Barnes right there was key because that was probably O'Neal, the safety, who's been downhill in the off-tackle gap almost all day long, and they finally cleaned it up, and Barnes got to him.
2:51 to go, third quarter.
Number 23, Isaac Carter, 2 to go.
Yeah, it was O'Neal that he got a piece of,
Yep, and O'Neal's the guy that all day, he's been that safety. He's the guy that's the furthest off the ball, and he's basically just mirroring the ball. And they finally got a piece of him right there.
So Isaac Carter comes in to kick off. 2:51 to go, third quarter. Taking it to 4. To the 20. And they'll get up over the 25 to the 27-yard line. This is where this Westinghouse team will be challenged now to try to get things going. I mean, possessions are going to be limited, especially against a team like this that runs the ball. And we saw time of possession at the half. It was heavily favoring.
It was almost 2-1.
Yeah, yeah. Southern Columbia.
Yeah, and look, they've got the ability, right? We, you know, Marcillo's legs, right? He's missed a couple deep balls. Still really haven't gotten Khalil Taylor going.
Mm-hmm.
But again, that's credit to this Tigers defense. They've played really well. And Coach Roth mentioned it, that they struggled defensively stopping the run early in the season. They had some uncharacteristic losses. But as the playoffs have gone on, they've gotten better.
Well, here's Taylor. Gainer close to 7, almost 8. He gets up over the 35 to the 36-yard line.
Nice little split zone right there. You saw Robinson, the fullback, the up back, coming back across. The O line's all zone blocking to the left. And nice read right there by Taylor hitting that hole.
Taylor again to the 40-yard line. That'll be enough to move the chains up over the 40. Treshiakis at the bottom of the pile, 74. It's Arnold that was at the bottom of the pile.
The quarterback, the end. D-tackle kicker, quarterback D-end.
Yep.
Upside down world.
That's Sean Robinson, 5 in the backfield. To the left, Marcillo, 1st and 10. The throw now, here comes the pressure. Sidesteps 1, down the middle of the field. And it's knocked away. Toslowski was there, nearly had the interception.
Toslowski probably should have had that. He's down. Probably from hitting the ground, catching his breath. That ball floated on Marcillo right there. Pressure in his face. Great job getting outside the pocket. That's the blitz that came clean last time. Underthrows it. Toslowski just mistimes the jump.
Yep. That nearly goes to Westinghouse for that completion.
Yep.
So it brings up a 2nd and 10 from the 40. 1:45 to go. Marcillo again, straight quarterback keep. There's Fedorov, stands him up. Great second effort. Gain of 6. 3rd down and 4.
It's a nice job right there. A little QB counter. Again, nice job by Marcillo. The ball's a little loose. Little ball security issues, and you see the Southern Columbia defense trying to strip it from him as he's dragging him down the field for a couple extra yards. That was a big play right there to get them back into kind of a manageable 3rd down here. You got to respect everything here, the run, the pass. Now, this is maybe 2-down territory at this point in the football game where they are on the field.
Robinson comes in. Marcillo looking that way. Going to throw back over the middle, and it goes through the hands of his intended receiver and falls incomplete.
Jones, the intended receiver, yep. Number 11, running a little crossing route right there. They tried to get Marcillo out of the pocket. They've had some edge pressure right there. He's got Marcillo. They just can't quite connect today. Marcillo can't quite get his guys. I mean, he's had 3 or 4 opportunities with guys downfield and just can't quite put the ball where they can catch it.
I know there's a whole quarter to go, but this almost could come down to this being the game right now.
Yeah.
57 seconds to go, 3rd quarter. 4th down and 4. Marcillo, here comes the pressure screen. This is the Taylor. He'll get the 1st down and more, and he's still going. Look at this, down the near sideline. Taylor will score. How about that? Wow.
Great call. Great play call right there by the Bulldogs offense. They've been getting 6-man pressure every 3rd and long. A little screen, and then a great effort by Taylor. That's the guy we've been waiting to see right there. Spins out of an arm tackle. Next thing you know, he's walking the tightrope down the sideline. Great call, great execution, great individual effort by Taylor to put that thing away.
Lining up, going for 2, odd formation. They'll throw the bubble screen, and the penalty flag is down. For now, it is a successful 2-point conversion. So they might have gotten Deshaun Blackwell for a holding penalty. It was complete to Jones.
Offense, number 1. We will redo the try.
The old redo. You can see out here, a little weird kind of formation. Number 1. Oh, yeah. He got beat off the jump there. And made a nice tackle. That's post tackle.
So this will go back to the 12-yard line. They'll retry the two-point conversion. I don't know if this is that big of a deal for this offense. Robinson, Taylor in the backfield with Morcillo. The throw, pressure again to the end zone. Complete two. It's Jones.
Sometimes that's a little bit more just, you know, again, it doesn't get him ahead or tie him up. They still have to score again. They can't really kick the ball, right? So it's got to be a touchdown. But at the end of the day, it's the emotional boost, right? They get the penalty there to get held out of it, and then they get it again. So, again, that's a great end right here. Good call. Again, get your guy out on the edge. Morcillo with a nice throw, nice catch. Again, he's had a little bit of trouble putting the ball where it needs to be, but that was a great job right there. Way to answer. Great drive.
That was.
And they got Taylor going, right, in a creative way. It's a little screen, a great play call. It really was. I mean,
yeah.
third and four, third and six, whatever it was, right, every third down, Southern Columbia has brought six and played man behind it. Great job getting the screen and then executing. They missed on one earlier today. Good job. And then just, like I said, great individual effort to run through some tackles by Taylor.
So 15-14 with 44 seconds to go in the third. One hopper at the 20-yard line. Wozlowski takes it. I'm sorry, that's...
It was Wozlowski. Yep, yep. It was. Yep, there he is, getting up again. That dude plays hard. Nice tackle there, too, by number 10, Troy Brown. Again, these guys, this has been such a physical football game. It's been really fun to watch. I mean, just from a, you know, just a fan's perspective, these guys are absolutely battling out there.
So from the 40, good field position again for Southern Columbia. Wozlowski or motion back. He'll get it. He'll go right side and try to bounce it outside. And he falls forward for a gain of close to 11. I don't know if they've got an answer. That's that off tackle. I don't know if they've got an answer for that play right
now. Yeah, they found something here. They're kind of getting out here and maybe change the blocking up a little bit. Or again, you know, look, as punishing as this defense has been, Wozlowski runs hard, and that has a toll on your safeties and your linebackers. Also, when they're hitting a guy that runs like that over and over again.
And Treshock had a big block on that last play. Under 10 seconds to go in the third. Madden, this near side this time, nowhere to go. He'll lose a couple. Back to the 49-yard line of Southern Columbia. And that's your final play of the third quarter. What a great ball game we have here in game number one of two this afternoon on PCN. 15-14, Southern Columbia takes a one-point lead into the fourth.
Changed since 1932.
But one thing that hasn't is Faulkner's commitment to Central PA.
Our organization is built on values like honesty, integrity, and trust.
Our prices are low and transparent.
Our buying experience is fast and easy.
And we're active in the community, supporting our friends and neighbors at charitable events, local games, and fundraisers. We remain committed to you and our community, to be sure.
What are these people running from? Nothing. They're running to watch Pennsylvania's Neighborhood on PCN, featuring Chester County. Experience the history and culture. Enjoy the meals and treats. Watch Pennsylvania's Neighborhood on PCN, Chester County, starting December 12th. PCN is everything Pennsylvania.
PCN is proud to bring you 2023 Pennsylvania Farm Show coverage this January 7th through the 14th. Get more information at PCNTV.com. Farm Show is going to be exciting. This fourth quarter is going to be exciting between these two teams. A one-point Southern Columbia lead. They face a second down and 12 from their own 49. Here's Wes Barnes testing the right side. Has the edge. A penalty flag is down. So we'll get a holding penalty on Southern Columbia. Negates about a, well, almost a 10-yard run, maybe 11-yard run for Barnes. Boy, every possession, every snap is crucial now.
Yeah, with the way that these guys run the football on both sides, you never know which one's going to pop.
Holding. Offense, number 30. 10 yards to the spot of the foul. 3-point second down.
Out there on the edge, you know, there were a couple plays earlier in the game where you kind of could have gone either way with, with holding on the front side, and you know, it looks like Kerstetter got caught that time.
Second down and 22. Poor guy's a tight end, does nothing but block, has right. one reception all year.
Might as well be wearing number 7.
Yep.
But hey, look, this is, again, I think this is four down territory, depending on what happens here on this play.
There's Wislowski. He'll get the carry, counter to Murphy, defended well by Westinghouse. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it, a 39-yard line.
Might have been Dante Taylor in there, number 52. They've caught on to that one a little bit. They've had some success with that counter. Good job knocking people backwards by the big guys inside.
Was Taylor, the 295-pound senior, third down and 22 from the Southern Columbia 39. Wise the throw, looking left side. Oh. There it is to Wislowski, who got a quick release off the line of scrimmage. He'll spin through a tackler, and he will score. Wow, how about that for Southern Columbia? 61 yards.
Man, how strong is that? I mean, that kid is ridiculous. They just ran four verticals right there. Everybody, you know, two receivers on each side. Wislowski runs right up the hash. Ball's put where only he can catch it. And then, I mean, now you've got a steamroller rolling out there through your secondary. I mean, that kid just plays hard. That was huge.
Fourth receiving touchdown of the season for Wislowski to go along with his 25 now rushing touchdowns. That is the seventh touchdown passing for Wise here today. Extra point from Isaac Carter.
Is he the long snapper, too?
Yes, he is. Yes.
I love it.
That's right. This one is true. Make it 22-14.
That's huge. I mean, huge. Third and a million for a wing T offense. Just pick it up, chuck it down the field to your best football player. Wislowski does the rest. Spins out of a tackle, spins out of another tackle, and then uses his speed to run past everybody. What a day he's having.
Early nomination for player of the game, right? If they hold on to this
one. Yeah, he's definitely making a case.
Plenty of time left, however, for Westinghouse, down 8. Remember, their last touchdown, they were successful. And they threw the ball a lot better with Morcillo. So we'll have to wait and see if that's going to be an objective. They have plenty of time, 10:34 to go, with this, the way this team can move the ball.
43, Isaac Carter, to kick off for Southern Columbia. Back deep for Westinghouse, the great Sincere Smith. Devon Jones.
So Devon Jones and Sincere Smith are back deep. Jones had the successful two-point conversion reception in this near corner. Isaac Carter, the kicker. From the two. Trying to find an open lane on this near side. Nowhere to go. Not great field position. I think they got back to the 15-yard line. It was Smith.
He's run down by number 9.
They're going to mark him at the 16.
5 on the play.
Brecton Reamer with a nice play on special teams, number 9.
personal foul. Tripping. Receiving team. Oh. Half the distance to the goal. First step.
So mark this nose of the football at the 8. Taylor, right side, behind Robinson. They try to string him out, and they do. He's going to lose a couple. He'll lose 3 for back to the 5.
Nice play by Barnes, fullback linebacker. Right, you see him, watch him. He's right there on the left. Watch him track this football. Watch him track that. Watch him track that. That's amazing. That is absolute textbook inside linebacker play. You track the hip, chase it down, tackle the legs.
Jim Roth said since he's been back, he's extremely disruptive. There's an example. So now you lose 3, second down and 13. Penalty moved you back half the distance, 8 yards, back to the 8. Now you're at the 5. Taylor is to the left of Morcillo. The throw. They fake a little pump and go. Deep down this near sideline and again overthrown.
Morcillo looks like he took a shot.
Smith was the intended receiver. But they had 2 defenders.
That was well played there by Southern Columbia. That's the old, you know, bubble and go, right? And the guy that's supposed to go block the corner just runs a streak. When they see that bubble action, you're trying to get one of those DBs to bite up, or both of them to bite. Really great eye discipline right there by the secondary of Southern Columbia.
Robinson comes out. That means 4 wide receivers come in. Taylor's the only back in the backfield for Morcillo. They've got double coverage once again on Smith near side. Here's Morcillo. They're going to throw that way with a little screen set up. He shakes away 1. Penalty flag is down. And he'll spin and dive forward up to about the 17, 18-yard line. But I think they might have gotten Westinghouse for a hold on the edge.
He's brought down by number 2, Carter Manning. Flag on the play.
Went back to that little tunnel screen. Trips into the boundary. Isolate somebody out on the field.
Ineligible downfield. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Replay 3rd down.
So he caught the ball on the other side of the line of scrimmage. Right? If your offensive linemen are down the field, you have to catch the ball behind the line of scrimmage.
So this moves the ball back to the 3.5.
And look, like everybody, anybody in football, self-inflicted wounds are hard to overcome. And when Westinghouse has avoided those things, the procedural stuff, the penalties, the holding, the little things like that, they've moved the ball quite well, but they put themselves into bad situations because of, you know, penalty flags.
Play fake to Taylor. Morcillo deep over the middle again as an open receiver, but just a little bit overthrown.
It's kind of been the story of the day right there for Morcillo as far as throwing the football. He missed Jones there again, running kind of right down the middle of the defense. He had him too. That's right on the hash. That's the 3rd or 4th one that I'm sure he'd like to have back. And now you're punting out of your end zone with a group that, you know, is a little shaky operationally.
Michael Richardson comes in to punt. Has to be careful not to step on that back line. This should set up Southern Columbia with tremendous field position. They're going to let this one bounce at the 35, and it takes a Southern Columbia bounce, and they'll down it at the 35-yard line. So the Tigers, with 8:55 to go, up 8, have an opportunity to pretty much ice this game.
Yeah, this is huge because a couple things, right? You're probably going to see them really try and grind this thing out, eat the clock, punch it in. That's the goal. Chew up as much clock as possible, come away with a touchdown, put the ball back in the Bulldogs' offense's hands with not enough time and too far to go.
First and 10 from the 35. And here's Murphy for the touchdown. How about that one play, 35 yards?
I feel like they were misaligned there defensively, the Bulldogs. It looked like they were moving, and they got caught in something there because that was too easy. Watch them. See how they're all moving? Look at the D-line all moving to the left there, right? And then look, you know, Southern Columbia just happened to be running the football right where those guys were all vacating. That was the easiest one of the day.
Fourth, make that the 10th rushing touchdown of the season for Loudon Murphy. Murphy a junior. Isaac Carter in for the PAT. Murphy is the holder.
Oh.
It's good.
You know, one thing that I mean, look, they scored up by two touchdowns. That's a couple scores, right? But, like, they didn't eat any clock. Didn't eat any clock up right there. So now you, if you're Westinghouse, right, you go out and you run your offense. Now you can't get
right.
Penalties. They cannot have self-inflicted wounds, and that's what's killed them on all the drives that they've really struggled on, where they've been pinned, where they've given Southern Columbia a great field position. See that little stem right there, little slant there? I feel like they were out of position. They were a little out of whack right there, and it happened to be exactly where the Tigers were running that play. But from an offensive standpoint, right, just don't get behind the sticks, no false starts, no holdings, play clean, move the football. Don't panic, though. I mean, there is still time.
Oh, yeah. And Tyler Arnold was in at quarterback on that last possession. So Jones and Smith once again back deep. Isaac Carter with the boot. 8:47 to go, a 15-point lead for the Tigers. And they'll let this one go into the end zone.
As a coach right now, you got to get in that huddle and you just got to keep your heads up, keep your composure. It's not over. Go play ball. Go do what we do. Get the ball in your playmaker's hands. Get it to Taylor. Right. Run more solo a little bit. You know, they tried to take some shots, which I understand, and then they've been so close today.
Yeah, that's the thing.
So close on the big ones. But you got to give yourself a little bit of wiggle room here, and you also can't. You know, they had that really nice tunnel screen that came back with the illegal man downfield. It's those kind of plays that are killing them right now. It gave Southern Columbia an opportunity to have a short field and score in one play.
So they'll go four wide receivers, two on either side from the 20-yard line. Motion near side for Westinghouse. Marcillo rolling that way. Again, a deep throw. Has a receiver open. This one well overthrown. It's all deep shots down the field. And again, every time the receiver has a step or two,
yeah,
but they just can't make that connection.
They're not connected right now. And this is definitely, you know, obviously Marcillo's a little frustrated. He knows he's got a couple that have had an opportunity. But you don't have to take the huge shot, right? I mean, you can run a crossing route, do some things. They're playing man coverage. You see the guys when they're running, when they're motioning receivers, you're watching the defensive backs chase, so you know what you're getting in coverage, right? Run a mesh route, run a pick play, a rub route, as they like to call it on offense.
Looking for Sincere Smith. Pressure's coming. Marcillo's got to run it. He fumbles the football, and Southern Columbia's got it.
That's a tough play right there for Marcillo. Great hustle right there, though. Kicker DT.
Right. He's the one who knocked it out.
Carter, great job chasing that thing down. Marcelo doesn't see what he likes. Dodges the first one. Watch Carter right there. That right arm gets in there, strips that thing out. Ball comes out.
Deal got it,
hustling from the backside, the big fella. Now you got a short field again. You got to keep playing. The Bulldogs have absolutely battled this entire game. You got to keep playing.
Arnold in at quarterback. False start, it looks like. Yep, on Southern Columbia.
False start. Offense, number 64. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
.31 to go, 15-point lead for the Tigers. Barnes is in the backfield, and he'll get the carry. Nowhere to go, maybe back to the line of scrimmage. They'll give him no gain to the 28-yard line. Second down and 10.
Yeah, they did.
I'm sorry, the second down and 15.
A little pre-snap movement again, a little stem of the line of scrimmage, and they put it in the right spot that time.
Please reset the game clock to 8 minutes and 20 seconds and start it on the whistle.
So no gain on first down, second down at 15, line of scrimmage is at 28. Wislowski and Barnes in the backfield. Here's Wislowski on the carry. He'll bounce it to the left, trying to get back to the line of scrimmage, and he won't do that. He'll lose a yard to the 29. And this Bulldog defense, back-to-back big plays, swarming to the football.
I absolutely love it. Look, they're not quitting. They're still playing. They're running around. This is a huge stop right here for them if they can do it. All right, wide little stem right there. Wislowski, they're moving the way they need to move. Again, there's no place for Wislowski to go, and great job being disciplined on the backside and available to make the tackle on the cutback.
Third down and 17. Madden, they fake it. Wise in the game, looking for an open receiver. And it goes incomplete. He was looking for Chrisman.
Number 10, please. Wise pass incomplete. Fourth down.
Little flood route right there. Everybody over there into the left side of the formation. Wise just kind of threw that one away.
So they're going to punt the ball from the 30-yard line. Nobody deep for Westinghouse. There's not much room to go deep. Carter, the punter, thought about it for a minute and then a little pooch punt. And it looks like they'll down this at the 16-yard line.
Good idea. Good idea.
6:52 to go in the fourth quarter. We'll step aside and come back with the conclusion of this one, the 2A championship after this.
Now listen up. You've got a job to do at the Farm Show. You've got to represent PCN. You have what you need. The PCN logo on your back, and you're squishy. So when a visitor comes to the PCN booth, you jump into their hand. Who's with me? That's right. Conserve your energy. Go get them.
The Pennsylvania Farm Show, starting January 7th.
It doesn't matter what part of the state you're from. One thing is certain. Pennsylvania loves sports. On the first Friday of the month, PCN takes you inside the lines at 6:30 p.m. PCN delivers insight from the people who cover sports from every corner of the Commonwealth. From high school to college to professional sports, PCN takes you inside the lines. Learn more at PCNTV.com.
.652 to go in the fourth quarter. Southern Columbia just punted to Westinghouse. They're down 15, 29-14. Bulldogs, with the speed and explosiveness that they have, could make a comeback here, but possessions are limited. Here's Morsillo on the quarterback keep, nowhere to go. He won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Carter's one of the guys there, along with 54 for Southern Columbia. It's a Bremigen in there.
Yeah, it is Bremigen. They tried to trap him. And really, that's on Morsillo right there. If you're going to pull somebody and trap him, you need to cut up underneath it. Flag on the plate.
start. Offense, number 8. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Again on one of the wide receivers. That's Sincere Smith that left a little bit early.
Yeah, that's tough. Those guys, they're taught to look at the football. Just like a D lineman, you're taught to look in at the ball. Don't listen to anything, and you don't need to be early.
Second down at 18. Morcillo again will keep it and run. And he'll get up to the 14-yard line, bring up a third down.
That's a good call. They're getting a lot of man-to-man right now. Southern Columbia's playing man coverage, which means, you know, they're probably going to bring a little pressure. If you can pop that quarterback draw when you got man coverage, that means your DBs, your secondaries, eyeing up their receivers so you don't have eyes on the quarterback. When you're playing zone, it's a little harder to run the QB draw because you got zone eyes on the QB.
Third down, Morcillo rolling. Going to look for a deep throw over the middle once again and slightly off target for his intended receiver. Hoy was on the coverage.
It's O'Neal.
He was looking for O'Neal.
O'Neal had a heck of a football game on defense. That kid's he hunts over there. I really enjoyed watching him play safety, but Morcillo's just been a little bit off today. You know, just a touch off on those deep balls especially, just a little bit too strong.
So Richardson comes in to punt once again. Another stop for the Tigers defense. No one back deep for Southern Columbia. It takes a Westinghouse bounce. It'll go into Tiger territory at the 45-yard line. 5:26 left in the fourth. 15-point lead for Southern Columbia.
On the Southern Columbia 45-yard line, that's where the Tigers take over first and 10.
This defense is battled, absolutely battled. Haven't had a lot of help from their offense this half, and then they've gone out there every single time and answered the bell for the most part. Again, like I said, they had that one big run.
Wislowski, Wise hands it to him. Little stiff arm. They'll spin him down at the original line of scrimmage. The clock will continue to move. And if you're Westinghouse now, you really want a turnover.
Yeah, you got to start stripping the ball. But you got to secure the tackle. I mean, that's the thing. When you're playing backs like these, you know, Barnes and Wislowski, and I mean, that's you got to secure the tackle. Somebody's got to secure the tackle. Then the next guy in rips the ball out. But what you don't want to do is go for the ball, not make the tackle, and allow the Tigers to score again. This group runs so hard.
Offset backs again, Wislowski and Barnes. Second down and 10. Here's Barnes on the quick hitter up the middle. Maybe a touchdown saver there as he tripped up.
He knows it too. He knows it. There's O'Neal again. See him sitting right there. Oop, just fill the hole. Shoestring tackle. He's been everywhere.
PIAA championship games are the exclusive property of the PIAA. Television coverage is licensed to PCN, whose exclusive rights are protected by federal copyright law. Any retransmission of any kind or other use of the television coverage of this game without the expressed written consent of PIAA is prohibited by law. We've got ourselves a game here, 29-14. The Tigers trying to put this one away. Once again,
Bumble
on the quick hitter.
Bumble.
Ball's out. Westinghouse has it. Well, they got the turnover they needed.
Wow. Barnes looked like he just ran into almost an offensive lineman's back, and the ball comes in. Let's see what happens here. Oh, yep, there's some, see that right there? 28-50. Somebody gets the hand on the ball right there. I can't tell who that was. It was either 55, Sincere Shannon, Robinson, but that was a huge play.
Well, gain of close to 8 on first down. So it was Sincere Shannon, 55, that did make the play of the junior.
Stop at number three, Barnes.
Now a gain of three, second down, or gain of seven, second down and three from the 47. Bulldogs aren't done just yet. You got Robinson and Taylor in the backfield with Morcillo. He'll throw. Looking deep again, over the middle, receiver's there. This time he makes the connection for the touchdown from 47 yards out, and the Bulldogs are not done. It's Devon Jones.
There it is, Morcillo, he found it. Finally connects, very timely. 3 minutes left in the game, you get the turnover, take advantage of it, take your shot. Perfect throw right there. Hits Jones in stride.
So they're gonna go for two. Morcillo, a little bubble screen. They ran this earlier. It's successful for two. Make it 29-22. They're down seven. Jones again, his second two-point reception of the day.
I love it. Just keep battling. Bulldogs getting after it, right? Playing great defense. This defense hasn't quit. 55 since here. Shannon with the big strip right there. Get the ball back, and here's the shot. Morcillo finally connecting. That's got to feel good right there after all those near misses.
We got ourselves the game, 3:08 to go. Bulldogs have three timeouts.
You gotta figure you're gonna get some sort of onside kick here.
You might as well, right?
Yeah,
because
absolutely.
They haven't been able to really kick it that deep.
No.
The Tigers think they're gonna get that.
Yep. Maybe this is one of those situations where you try and bloop it or kick it a line drive right between everybody and just run past people and get it.
Asavia Martin is the kicker, number 54. And Wozlowski is the deep guy. He's standing at the 30-yard line. There's the onside attempt, and it does not go the necessary yardage.
Not an easy thing to do.
Not at all. And you don't know how many times a team that's won by this many points throughout the course of the season has even attempted an onside,
right, yeah,
or even worked on that in practice.
Yeah, you try and do it.
The ruling on the field is first touched by the kicking team. Southern Columbia ball at the first down.
Bulldogs have all their timeouts left. You know, Southern Columbia's in their 4-minute offense, but they were, you know, get the ball out.
Please reset the game clock to 3:08.
From the 45. See if this defense can come up big once again.
Yep, off. False start, right guard. Yep. Put his hand down, pop back up, make a little gopher.
False start, offense, number 72. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Brett Horton, you see him right there, the right guard. Whoop, he pops up, he's getting ready to pull. And they caught him.
First and 15, now from midfield. Barnes, Wozlowski, here's Barnes. He'll feed him to the 40, bounces outside, gets a block, to the 25, 20, 10, 5, and knocked out of bounds. One run and the Tigers are in business.
Nice lead block right there. Carter Madden springs Barnes for a huge run. Tough. This defense has played so hard today. It's so hard to stop this offense consistently over and over and over again.
They move the ball back to the 10-yard line.
The rule of the field is the runner stepped out at the 10. First and goal, Southern Columbia.
All right.
So 2:57 to go.
I
personnel changes here. Play clock is under 10 seconds. Yeah, they have to take a timeout. Yep. They had some late adjustments.
Substitutions,
and then Murphy was out of alignment.
Timeout. Southern Columbia, their second of the half.
The substitution issue, Coach Roth right there. A little frustrated. All right, he knows how big this is, having to burn a timeout. Also gives, you know, the Bulldogs defense an opportunity to regroup and catch their breath and talk a little bit to their coaches right there at the numbers. And so everybody's getting a good talking to on both sides here, getting a sip of water, getting pumped up, or getting scolded for messing up the substitution, one or the other.
So this team has played in 76 PIAA games, and they've won 60 of those. And they are looking for their 13th state championship and sixth in a row. They've been to 8 in a row, which is impressive. They've bumped up a class from single A. Now they're a double A, and they continue to lead with 2:57 to go. Wise under center. Barnes. To the nine.
They've had to earn it today. There's no doubt about it. They've got their big runs. They've had their big plays. It's a Southern Columbia offense, they've had to earn every single bit of it. These tailbacks, these guys running the football are going to be absolutely sore tomorrow. Let the play clock run down. Milk as much time as they can.
There's Madden in motion. He'll get the carry. He's ahead of Horton, and he's in. Touchdown, Southern Columbia.
He got in front of his guard there.
Yeah, how about that?
Horton might have been a little slow because he didn't want to jump off sides again. But, yeah, watch this come around. He gets in front of Horton. Great job, though, getting up in front of everybody, making great blocks. I think it was – who else was out there? Kerstetter got in front of him. Treshock.
Isaac Carter tried for the point after.
13th rushing touchdown of the season for Carter Madden. Murphy for two. Number 27-22 is your score.
Yeah, that big run by Barnes right here. There's Madden with the block. Barnes with the big run. All the way down to the 10. All right, and then for your efforts, young man, here's the football. Get in the end zone. Madden does. That should just about do it right there. I mean, that's what a great offense does, that's why this program is where they are. They've absolutely battled. This has not been an easy one. I've seen them here, like they did last year, absolutely run through people. I think Westinghouse has played a great football game defensively. They've been as stout as anybody, and they've made the Southern Columbia offense earn it. They just too many missed opportunities offensively and a couple turnovers that were really costly.
The lead back up to 15 with 2:04 to go. I mean, this team. Yep. Westinghouse can score quickly, but I think that's asking a little bit too much. They've got all three timeouts. Devon Jones will take it at the 10. And they'll stand him up right around the 25-yard line.
Ball might have come out there.
Well,
they're selling it if it didn't.
They're saying that it... That was Smith with it, and it looks like Southern Columbia sold it. That was Smith on the return.
And it looks like Yeah, I think the ball definitely came out. It came out. That was a good job.
The ruling on the field is a fumble recovered by Southern Columbia. First down at the 25. Timeout.
Bulldog down over there. Little jump cut and see the ball in there. Yeah, it pops out. It looks like it was Colton Bloom, tight end number 31, running down on special teams. It pops that thing out.
Ethan Mikowski is the guy that got the recovery. Yep. That's a freshman that fell on it.
Sincere Smith.
That's who had the carry, yeah. The return, yeah. Yeah.
Hopefully he's okay once he gets himself sorted out. Played well today. He played hard.
Arnold in at quarterback for Southern Columbia. He'll run Barnes. And he'll fall forward to close to the 20-yard line, a gain of almost five.
Head off to number three, Wes Barnes. He stopped at number 20, Cameron Mitchell. Second down.
And let the play clock wind down here, milk it all, you know, try and eat the rest of this game up. And Coach Green's got his group on the sideline right now talking to him. I'm sure telling him, hey, you guys had a great year. Keep your heads up, right? Finish this thing the right way, right? Doesn't look like they're going to burn the timeouts.
Arnold to keep it.
Yep. Stay in bounds.
14, Tyler Arnold, quarterback. Stop at number 20, Mitchell.
Under a minute to go now.
This game will beat our two championship teams with our trophy presentations. Spectators are reminded you are not permitted onto the track and not over the playing surface.
This was a fun football game, right?
Yeah,
this really was. This was, these two guys, they got after it today. This was well played.
Two physical football teams.
Yeah, well coached.
Yep.
Well coached, and the difference was those little mistakes, you know, the turnovers, the misses on the long shots, some penalties.
Other things to need.
Heck of a game.
That should be the final snap. Southern Columbia, six consecutive PIAA football championships. And that will do it. 37-22 is your final. We will come back with the post-game awards after this. for their head. He's in the open. He is all-time wins in the country. Is now 484. But a great effort for Westinghouse. The Bulldogs representing the City League. The first time a team has been in the finals. Perry is the only team to ever win a state championship. Yeah. Since he's are going to continue.
This is a tough one, right? This is tough for the Bulldogs. They battled, you know, to get here, to have a storybook season, right, and to have it end this way. It's hard, right? And it should hurt, right? It hurts because it's important. It hurts because you put everything into it. But those kids. Going to feel. The ball. Definitely bittersweet, right? They'll be proud of it. They'll talk about it when they grow up, right? Whenever they get together again. But it's going to be a long ride home.
Well, 39 wins for Dante Green in his four seasons. And while Southern Columbia is going to get another championship trophy, kind of kidded around that every one of these senior classes doesn't want to be the one that loses this string. Now six consecutive. Both fan bases very supportive here this afternoon.
Great crowd. It was fun. We're having a cool thing. It fills the stands. A lot of energy.
Captain's about to receive.
Pretty amazing accomplishment.
Yeah, it is.
It's hard enough to win one of them. They earned every bit of that one today.
Yeah, they did.
Absolutely earned every bit of it.
One of the closer championship games that they've played in, that's for sure.
Yep, and it was as physical a football game as I think I've seen. Level in a long time.
All right, it's time now for our Lebanon Valley College player of the game. Lebanon Valley College listed number one in Pennsylvania for job placement. Lebanon Valley College. Today's player of the game is Braden Wislowski. And he deserved it. He did everything. I think he drove the bus here, right? He did everything.
Yeah. It's everywhere, right? Strong. Hard to get your hands on. Increases. This right here. Since for a wing tee offense and gets a nice ball right there from Wise. And then not only does he get the first down.
Carries for
100.
I hope you enjoy the two at the service and and at the Pennsylvania Cable Network. And for my partner, Brandon Noble, I'm Doug Heater, saying so long from Cumberland Valley High School, Southern Columbia, your PIAA 2A state champs.
The 2022 PIAA